The quarterback is Cade Bell, an all-Pioneer first-team selection a season ago. Running back, Ulysses Bryant. He ran for 1,000 yards last season. Four wide receivers, Andy Jones, Damian Strange, Prince Gray, and Brian Burnett. The left tackle is Trayvon Wallace. Left guard, Kevin Battle. Center is Logan Williamson. Right guard, Tyler Adrian. And right tackle is Mark Bodkick. Going up against that starting lineup for Jacksonville on offense is the Delaware defense. Got some youth there, but some experience on the defensive line, including Captain David Tinsley, Blaine Woodson, Josh Plummer, and Vince Hollerman. The linebacking core of Kendall, Bell, and Jackson, and the secondary young as well. Two freshman starters, Ray Jones and Asir Adderley, Justin Watson, and Ryan Torza round out the starters for Delaware. We'll see Kevin McLaughlin out there to start the season off with his kickoff, kicking south to north. His back to the student section. A lot of excitement here in the stadium, Matt. We're almost ready to go.
Yeah, you know that this is a big moment. Delaware's entire team standing on the edge of the sideline. The student section here early, which is a great thing to see at Delaware Stadium.
McLaughlin has it teed up. Bryant back to return. Bryant and Quadio. And we are underway here at Delaware Stadium. The return for Jacksonville out of the end zone at the 5 to the 10, running near the Delaware sideline at the 14-yard line. And that's where Jacksonville will start. And that was Wes Hills making the tackle on special teams for Hills, his 15th career tackle.
Yeah, and the reason why Wes Hills is a junior this season and not a redshirt sophomore is his prowess on special teams. He was so good right away. Dave Brock and his staff saw they needed to get him on the field as a true freshman, and he was a special teams whiz, and that tells you how good he is at it. I know Dave Brock puts a lot of emphasis on special teams, but Hills has a chance to be a historic back in Delaware's offense, and yet he's still out there on kick coverage.
Quadio is the running back as Bell starts in shotgun formation. First play of the season from scrimmage. And we get a flag as there was some motion by Jacksonville. That's Andy Jones, a senior. Don't expect that on the first play from a senior who had 46 catches last season.
Too amped up. I mean, that was point blank, just ready to go. They were going to go on first movement. They've obviously worked on a silent count, expecting a big crowd, much bigger than Jacksonville's used to playing in front of, at least.
That makes it first and 15 back at the 10-yard line to start the season off for Jacksonville. Bell in shotgun again. Lefty quarterback. He's going to keep it. Throwing. And a miscommunication over the head of his intended target near the 30-yard line. He was looking for Prince Gray near the Jacksonville sideline. On it, second down and 15.
Boy, he had Damian Strange wide open underneath. Instead, he wanted to take the shot. And here's another guy, an experienced quarterback, I think a little too hyped up for that first play. Maybe the penalty getting him behind the sticks, a first down and long, made him take a chance he didn't need to there.
Bell threw for 60% last season. Starts 0-1, second and 15. Four wide receivers. Bell rolling out across his body, finds his man at the 18-yard line, we'll call it. And it'll be third down for Jacksonville.
A pretty good coverage by Ryan Torza. Took away the underneath route immediately. Bell, though, did a good job to buy time, eluded to the outside, flushed out of the pocket, and that forced Torza to commit forward, opened up the receiver.
Nickel package in for Delaware. We see Casey Hinton in his first action as a true freshman. Third down and 7 for Bell from the 18-yard line. High snap, dropping back is Bell. Pressure coming. He releases. Ball is caught by Jones, running at the 30-yard line, diagonally to the 36, and out of bounds. That's a first down pickup for Jacksonville. They were first in the Pioneer League last season in third down conversions. They start 1-1 today.
And they did a good job that time. They spread the field, and they got Charles Bell, a linebacker, a very good linebacker, isolated against their wide receiver. Bell just flat out cannot run with Andy Jones, who sprinted away from him.
On first and 10 from the 38, the give is to the back, Quadio. He gets to the 40-yard line before the captain, David Tinsley, makes the stop.
If you're Delaware, that third down pickup, though, really does have to feel a little backbreaking. Remember that game against Villanova? How many opportunities did they have to win it on that final drive for third and fourth down conversions? And it was a repeating storyline against this Delaware defense last season.
Balance set. Two wide receivers on both sides of Bell on second and 8 from the 40. Play action pass. Rolling out. Throwing on the run. Has his man in Delaware territory. Caught at the 39-yard line. And the tackle made by Charles Bell.
That time it was Bell stuck on Strange. They're spreading Delaware's defense out. They're finding opportunities with wide receivers against linebackers. As good as Bell is, he's going to have a hard time running with that kind of speed.
Catch was made by Brian Burnett. 22-yard pickup for Bell. First and 10 of the Delaware 38. Screen pass is caught at the 30 to the 20 and brought down by Bell again, but a first down pickup for Jacksonville again. That time it was Damian Strange.
Spectacular kick out block that time by Robert Ritteroff. Just absolutely took the ball. Nichols out of the play. Opened up big room on the outside.
13-02. No score. First quarter. First drive for Jacksonville. Ball on the Delaware 24-yard line. Trips to the right side. That's where the tight end is. And another flag is thrown. That's the second of the day. And on this drive, it'll be against Jacksonville again.
I wonder if that was the center. We don't have the referee mic right now, but it was the umpire standing behind the play. Looked like he was staring dead in the middle. I didn't see any kind of a flinch whatsoever, so you wonder if that was the squeeze of the football, the simulated snap call that time.
Cade Bell, 4 of 5 on this drive, 64 yards. First possession of the game for Jacksonville. It's first and 15, trips to the right, in motion goes Quadio to the lefty quarterback. Plenty of time to throw, going for the end zone, and it's out of bounds at the 2, intended target, Amoni Williams.
Spectacular coverage that time by Justin Watson, the redshirt sophomore, running step for step up the near sideline. Just nowhere for Bell to put that football. The difference between Bell this year and Bell, what we saw a couple of seasons ago, his ability to throw that ball to the outside. When they played against Delaware here 2 seasons ago, that would have been a turnover. He made too many mistakes.
Now second down and 15, ball in the Delaware 29-yard line. No score, first drive, 5 wide receivers. Bell thought about the shovel pass, will keep it himself, dragged down from behind at the 23-yard line. Looked like Woodson wrapped him up.
Well, that was David Tinsley, the captain again, I think doing a good job of figuring out what that play was. He diagnosed it, and then he got in the path. But Cade Bell, another good decision, another nice job of changing his mind, sticking with the play, and getting himself into a third down and reasonably manageable.
Single back Quadio on third down and 8. 12 minutes, first quarter action. Jacksonville's first drive. Wide receivers bunched to the right. Bell steps into a throw. At the first down marker, it's caught, but I believe just a bit shy. They needed to get inside the 15, and it's marked at the 15. Nice tackle by the freshman getting his first start, Nasir Adderley.
What a great play by Adderley. You want to talk about a freshman, that's a do-or-die play. If he times that wrong and or does not make the tackle, it's a touchdown. Adderley, complete faith in his ability, drove hard on the football, sure-handed tackle in the open field, and now a fourth down decision where Jacksonville's going to keep the offense out there.
They do have a very good kicker in Brandon Burr, but they're going to go for it on fourth down and 1 from the Delaware 15 inside the red zone. Bell being chased, throwing on the run, caught to Jones, and that's a first down conversion to the 13-yard line.
Well, Delaware got good pressure straight up the middle that time as Anthony Jackson came on a blitz, picked the gap perfectly, timed it pretty well. Just unfortunately for him, it was a design play rolling to the outside away from where he blitzed from, and Bell had just enough time to find the man in the flat that time. Pretty good throw.
Drive continues for Jacksonville. Near side hash inside the red zone. At the 12-yard line, Bell talking to his wide receivers, changing the play at the line. The back is France Quadio, the senior. High snap. Bell going towards the end zone and too far for his intended target. Good coverage by Justin Watson.
Well, they wanted to get that ball to Prince Gray that time. Double move on the outside. Again, a little surprising. Andy Jones came wide open in the flat. Cade Bell really taking some chances here on that first drive. An anticipatory throw. He threw that ball well before Gray came out of his break, and the timing was a little off.
Second down and 10, ball on the 12-yard line. 10:40, first quarter, no score. First drive of the 2015 season. Cade Bell, 5 of 7, 71 yards on this drive. And a converted fourth down a moment ago. Bell back in shotgun. Two receivers to the left and a tight end. Bell going to keep it. Stepping up in the pocket. Flipping it to no one in particular. That might have been a fumble. I thought he went past the line of scrimmage. And he did. Ball is live. Running down the field with the football is Ray Jones. Buck starts the season with a fumble recovery touchdown.
Boy, I'm happy, Scott. I don't think so, though. It sure looked like Cade Bell flipped that ball forward, and the officials are going to discuss it. I don't know how the ball would have possibly went forward if he fumbled it like that. I mean, nobody hit him from behind. It didn't seem like it slipped out. To me, it seemed like a pretty good, pretty clear pass. Give Delaware credit playing it out, though.
And they're going to call it an incomplete pass.
That's the right call.
That's the right call. That is the right call.
Yeah, you wanted it to be a fumble.
And I'll tell you, like you just said, heady play by Ray Jones. Until you hear that whistle, keep playing. So that was an incomplete pass. It was the correct call. He was not hit.
It's clear.
If anything, I thought he threw it past the line of scrimmage, and it could have been a penalty. But they're just going to call it an incomplete pass.
We just saw the replay. It was the old Tim Tebow-style jump pass. Now, he threw it away. There was a back in the area, so it wouldn't even be intentional grounding. Dave Brock has a good argument here, though, in this regard. Quite frankly, you can't not see that and then change your mind. How are there that many officials out there on the field? Nobody knows it's an incomplete pass, and then all of a sudden you decide, you know what, he threw the ball. That's the part that I think Brock argues, but if he looks at the screen, it was quite clearly a forward pass, and they did get it right. It just is pathetic how long it took to get there.
Yeah, I think they saw Ray Jones running into the end zone and finally realized, you know what, I think we got this one wrong. Bell in shotgun on 3rd and 10 from Delaware's 12-yard line. 4 wide receivers, 2 split out to the left. Bell looking that way, running up in the pocket, has some room, flag thrown. He slides at the 5, shy of the first down marker. And it is going to be a hold going against Jacksonville.
Blade Woodson got tackled that time. So Mark Bodkin just tackled Blade Woodson again. Good push from Woodson. That was a recurring storyline all last season. And Woodson got penetration again. Cade Bell, very impressive what he has done on this opening drive. I'm a little surprised, by the way. Wouldn't that make it 4th down? I'm a little surprised. I thought he slid down 3-4 yards shy of the first down. I would have thought he'd decline the penalty here.
Instead, it'll be 3rd down and 20. Outside the red zone now at the Delaware 22-yard line. Bell still in shotgun form. And Quadio still the back to his right. 4 wide receivers to choose from for Cade Bell. 10-17 first quarter action. No score, first drive. Bell looking to throw the football. Steps into a tight spiral. And he has a target in the end zone. Caught. And a touchdown for Jacksonville. An opening drive score for the Dolphins.
Boy, Delaware rolled the dice that time. I am 99% sure Cade Bell slid down shy of the first down. There was a little bit of confusion there with the flag, but it sure looked like the spot was going to be the 6 or 7, which would have been a 4th and 2 or a 4th and 3. Dave Brock felt more comfortable with a 3rd down and 20. Jacksonville, though, good protection for Bell. Steps up, accurate throw on the post.
Brandon Bear on for the extra point. He gets it. Your PNC Bank timeout score, Jacksonville 7, Delaware nothing.
This is Dr. Michael Axe of First Aid Orthopedics. Why should you go to First Aid Orthopedics for the care of your muscle, lung, and joint? Patients throughout the high
school. Top Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens.
Sports. Let's go Blue Hens.
At Domino's, choose any 2 medium 2 topping pizzas, pasta in a dish, sandwich, cheesy bread, or 8-piece wings or specialty chicken, and both are just $5.99 each. Visit Domino's.com.
You're listening to UD Football on 94.7 WDSD.
13 plays, 86 yards for Jacksonville. You're listening to 94.7 WDSD. And this game also on Sirius Satellite Radio, HSRN, partnering with the CAA this season. We're excited to be their first broadcast of the year. A bit of a roll of the dice for Delaware. The penalty prior to that, if they declined, would have been 4th down instead on 3rd and 20, a touchdown.
Well, I mean, you want to talk about a backbreaking turn of events there over a 3-snap series. You had what looked like maybe you'd get a gift touchdown, the no call by the officials on what was a clear near incomplete pass, but they let Ray Jones play on. He runs all the way down the field into the end zone. They finally called it back. Dave Brock absolutely lost it on the sideline, was still screaming at the official 2-3 plays later. And then on third down, Cade Bell steps up and runs, slides down shy of the first down. Would have been about a 4th and 2, 4th and 3, somewhere in that neighborhood. But a holding call, he elects to move them back, give them another third down, third and very long. Now, the defense has to be able to get off the field on third and very long, but a little surprised that he did not have them into a 4th and 3. I would have to think Jacksonville would have kicked the field goal.
Back to return for Delaware, Wes Hills. Under it at the 4, running to the 10, 15, now at the 20, has some blocking at the 25, to the 30, kicker ahead at the 40-yard line, and Delaware will start with great field position. Let's get to the starters, brought to you by National 5 and 10. The quarterback, well, we'll find out when you do. Looks like it's going to be Blake Rankin, the transfer from Rutgers. Jalen Randolph or Wes Hills, either one might start at running back position. Brandon Whaley's the tight end. Rick Bell, Trey Brown, Deontay Cherry, the wide receivers. The line from left to right. Curtis, Bozick, Kern, Lewis, and Trump will get you the starters defensively for Jacksonville after the first snap.
Boy, it is nice to have Wes Hills, though, isn't it? Right after you got that punch in the gut, a really tough thing to bounce back from. Hills provides the bounce back immediately with great field position. Almost took that one to the house.
Delaware will start the 2015 campaign on offense at their own 44-yard line, down 7-0, 10-01, first quarter. And some motion. And Rankin will give the ball to Jalen Randolph. Big hole into the second unit of the Jacksonville defense. A 9-yard pickup on the first play of the day into Jacksonville territory at the 47.
Little counteraction that time. Randolph, ball step to the right, then cuts back against the grain. Great blocking up front. Huge hole on the cutback. And a 9-yard pickup on first down. Boy, if you're picking up 9 yards on the ground all day, Delaware is going to hang a number on Jacksonville.
Randolph averaged 5.2 yards per carry a season ago. He's a single back now with Rankin under center on 2nd and 1 from the Jacksonville 47-yard line. Rankin will keep it on the ground. It's Randolph. Not as much doing on the second carry of the game, but he kept his feet turning. And he's going to be just shy of the first down marker. So it'll be third down and maybe a foot.
Boy, Jacksonville, I think they thought they knew what was coming that time. 8 guys all charging towards the line of the scrimmage at the snap of the football. We're going to see a lot of guys in the box, I think a lot, especially early in this season, until Delaware's quarterback situation proves itself. At Delaware's offensive line, sometimes it's a numbers game. There's not much you can do, no matter how good you are. If the other guy has more people, it's going to be hard to block that up.
Delaware going heavy. Yoakum into the game. Patton into the game as well. Offset eye for Rankin. And now 3 behind him on 3rd and 1 from the 47. It's Patton who gets his first career carry, and it's good for a first down to the 44-yard line.
Tell you what, Scott, if you are going to be the team that Delaware wants to this season, you have to pick up those third down and shorts. Delaware's probably got to be about an 85-90% team on third down and 2 or less. At that time, they picked it up with relative ease. Great blocking up front. That Delaware offensive line, 2 of the first 3 snaps, that's pretty good percentage.
And check that. That was Randolph again who got the first down yardage, 818 first quarter. Rankin will go under center. 1st and 10, single back for Rankin is Wes Hills. And Hills gets the carry, running diagonally back to the line of scrimmage at the 44-yard line. Tackle made by Grady Redding. He had 79 of those a season ago.
You know, at times last season, it was a series on, a series off. I like that, especially early in the season when it's hot, it's humid. Keep these guys fresh. Couple of snaps on, couple of snaps off, and always have a running back there who's 100% in terms of energy, and I think that's what you'll see more of this season from Delaware.
It'll be Hills again as a single back. Rankin in shotgun form this time. 4 wide receivers on 2nd down and 9 from the Jacksonville 43-yard line. And Rankin going to roll. He pumps, tucks, has some space at the 40, 35-yard line. His helmet falls off. And down he goes at the 34-yard line. So whether Coach Brock was deciding to put Walker in or not, it's his turn because the helmet came off for Rankin, and we'll see Joe Walker's debut.
Boy, you like that, though, from Rankin. You know, Dave Brock was talking about that Joe Walker's a little bit better runner, but don't lose track of Blake Rankin because he's a pretty good guy. And so many times in the read option over the last few years, it was not a true threat for the quarterback position. Hurley wasn't slow of foot. He just wasn't incredibly athletic. Both of these QBs are. Rankin certainly showed it there.
And Joe Walker, the redshirt freshman, under center. Patton and Hills behind him. It goes to Hills, and he dives across the 30-yard line to the 29. It'll be second down and five.
You know, the conventional wisdom would suggest, as Rankins looks like going to come back into the game here for Delaware after he has to sit out the mandatory play, that Wes Hills would be the outside guy. Jalen Randolph would be between the tackles bruiser. That's not the case. Both of these guys can fill both of those roles, and I think that's another part of what makes Delaware so dangerous offensively when they run the ball.
Two tight ends set, Yoakum and Whaley in the game on second and five from the Jacksonville 29-yard line. Rankin keeps it on the ground. To the outside is Hills. He slipped one defender, was tackled at around the 25-yard line, but a flag on the play. Three flags on an opening drive for Jacksonville.
These are the types of things you cannot afford if you're Delaware. It was an illegal chop block that time on Delaware. Two guys engage, one up top, one comes down low, and that's a 15-yard penalty, and that's a killer because you got a young kid who hasn't even tried a pass yet, and that's what I was talking about in the pregame show. Not probably going to be big play heavy this season. You're going to have to manufacture these drives. It's going to have to be churning up 4, 5, 6, 7 yards a pop, and you get off schedule, it's going to be real hard to get back off.
And that was one of your keys, stay ahead of the sticks for these young quarterbacks. And that penalty not helping out.
And that's what happened when you don't have that big play threat vertically. Your execution has to be almost perfect in order to maintain these drives. It's what we saw from Michael Adenraje's team back in 2010 with Pat Devlin back there. They weren't a big play team, but they were able to just keep churning the chains up.
Rankin getting the call from the sideline. Looks like Devine is on the sideline. He went back and forth last season.
Well, that would make sense. He's such a good offensive line coach as well, and he can be down there with his guys in the trenches making the adjustments.
Yoakum in as the H-back, Rankin on second and 17 from the Jacksonville 41-yard line. Will roll, throwing across his body. It's deflected and incomplete. Pass knocked away by DJ Howard. An honorable mention, all Pioneer League selection a season ago. Third down and long coming up. Delaware down 7-0, 5:56, first quarter.
Shallow cross that time from Deontay Cherry. You know, it's dangerous, Havley, to throw the ball back across your body when rolling left. But Cherry was open. That was not a terrible decision. That was just a really good play by the linebacker. He was up near the line of scrimmage, peeled back. No way Rankin could have seen him slip into the passing lane that time.
First career pass for Blake Rankin. Starts 0-1. Jarman split out to the left. Five wide receivers, empty backfield. On third down and 17 from the Jacksonville 41-yard line. Rankin calling for it. Gets it. Pressure coming. Throwing. Middle of the field. Reaching for it is Cherry. But he's tackled at the 36-yard line. It's going to be fourth down and long for Delaware.
Three-man rush that time from Jacksonville. They sat back at a bubble near the first down marker. They said, if you want to throw it underneath, that's fine. We'll come up, gang tackle, and not allow you to run after the catch. Good decision by Rankin. He was looking vertically. There was nothing there. We both have a bird's-eye view. No one open. Take what you can. Play the field position here. Hope that one of the best punters in the country can back him up.
Anderson back to punt for the first time this season. Terrence Bryant back to return. It's fourth down and 12 from the Jacksonville 36. At midfield is Anderson. Steps into one. It's high. That one looking like it's going to land in the end zone, and it does. So a touchback with 5:11 remaining in the first quarter. Delaware down 7-0. Let's send it down to the sideline. And Michael Atanarase.
Hey, guys. What you saw right there on that last offensive drive is them get behind schedule like you guys talked about. We can't afford those penalties, especially with young quarterbacks, especially with a passing game.
Absolutely agree, and a good point from Michael on the sideline. 5:11 remaining in the first quarter. Jacksonville scores on their first drive of the day. Despite some penalties, they converted on third down and on fourth down on that drive, and they lead 7-0 here at Delaware Stadium.
Yeah, if you're the Delaware defense, played pretty well on first and second down, could not get off the field on third down. That was a recurring theme last season, and it's something that has to be fixed this year. I think the three things that Delaware has to fix this season: they got to tackle better, which didn't really come into play on that first drive. They've got to get off the field on third down, and they've got to find a way to create some turnovers. Those are the big things, especially with an inexperienced offense, which is going to struggle to throw the football at least early in the campaign. They have got to not only be better in those three categories, I think they have to excel in at least two of them.
Can't be much worse as far as turnovers gained for Delaware a season ago. They were 121 of 121, last in FCS football with just 10 turnovers gained a season ago. Hey, we looked pretty good out there during the pregame show. The setup was looking nice. Want to thank Shamrock Printing, who helped us with the signage. They're your local source for printing and promotion. Bring your idea to Shamrock Printing and let their creative design team bring your project to life, from cards and brochures to signs, posters, and banners. Shamrock Printing is your local source for quick, quality printing, located on Main Street in Newark.
One other silver lining here, Scott. Just remember this. 2 years ago, Delaware played Jacksonville in an opener. At about 9 minutes into the game, it was 14-0 Jacksonville. The Hens hung 51 on the Dolphins. Now, this is not the same offense that the Hens have today that they had 2 years ago, but take a deep breath. It's still very early.
This drive starts at the 20 for Jacksonville. 5:11 remaining in the first quarter. A 7-0 lead for the Dolphins. And on first down, a throw across the middle behind the intended target, which was Brian Burnett. 7 of 12 now is Cade Bell. 96 yards and a score on that first drive.
That is great defense by the umpire, William Thomas. I don't know if it's the former Eagles linebacker, William Thomas. He looked like a linebacker that time. He ran complete interference. The receiver never saw that ball coming. That was going to be 10 yards. Got to get a little bit better position on those cross-the-middle throws.
Trips to the right side for Bell on second down and 10. And in motion goes Brian Burnett. Bell thought about the screen, flips it to Quadio in the backfield. He stumbles across the 20-yard line to the 22. It was Charles Bell, the sophomore starting linebacker, with the tackle.
That was pretty well, I think, thought up there by Jacksonville. They bluffed the screen to the outside with two backs going either direction, hoping that they could draw the linebackers that way and then slip somebody over the middle. But Delaware did a good job staying at home, that middle of the Delaware defense, especially up front, expected to be strong. It was that time.
Only three down linemen for Delaware on third down and 8. From the 22 of Jacksonville territory, up 7-0, are the Dolphins with the football. Delaware showing some blitz. Bell takes the snap. Here comes pressure. He tries to avoid it. Pushes it ahead to his target at the 30-yard line. Pass is caught. First down is converted for Jacksonville. That was Prince Gray, and that was pretty creative from the senior Cade Bell.
Are we watching Cade Bell, or are we watching Ricky Santos, the old New Hampshire quarterback? Doesn't he look a lot like him, or maybe even a Doug Flutie?
He looked like a basketball player with that chest pass on the last throw. And now another procedure penalty against Jacksonville before first down and 10 at the Delaware 30, or at their own 32.
He looked like a little kid shooting a free throw the way he shot that one from down at the chest.
Another false start for Jacksonville. And that's their fourth penalty of the game so far.
And that might be the most concerning part here in the early going for Delaware, because Jacksonville has shot themselves in the foot a couple of different times. Unfortunately, I guess they've just been grazing blows. They haven't been in any way, shape, or form mortal, because the Dolphins have been able to recover off of it. And not even on first down. They've really made most of their hay on second and third down.
Jacksonville leads 7-0, 3:58, first quarter, first and 15 after the penalty, ball on their own 27. A draw play to the running back, and he is hit as he approaches the 29-yard line. That was Bilal Nichols, the Hudson Vo-Tech graduate.
Well, they tried to use Blaine Woodson's aggressiveness against him. Woodson got way up the field, but there's another guy in the middle, and Bilal Nichols did a good job, had two guys on him, and just shed the block, held his ground, a good tackle in space. There's one of those keys we were talking about, better tackling.
Bell will go back in shotgun on second down and 13, ball on the Jacksonville 29-yard line. Balance set, two wide receivers to both sides, Quadio the single back. As Bell takes the snap, dropping back, has some time, running out of time, running out of the pocket. Nichols gave him chase, but he got past the line of scrimmage, across the 35, out of bounds at the 37.
Hens are running some man coverage. The problem with man coverage, there's always going to be one guy unaccounted for, and left you're leaving the spy, and that's the quarterback. Cade Bell's doing a great job using his legs. He hasn't run a ton, but he's buying time. And if you have some vertical routes, there's just nobody there to tackle him, and that's what Bell took advantage of.
Jacksonville, 3 of 4 on third down conversions. It's 3rd and 4. Bell pumps left, sets up the screen on the opposite side, but threw it over the head of his intended target, Jamal Adjmahan. And it falls incomplete. 4th and 4 for Jacksonville. It was John Nassib who was giving him pressure.
Yeah, it was a great job by Nassib. Got into the backfield, realized it was a flare pass to the outside, and moved to the back. And that forced that high arcing throw from Bell. He had to throw it sooner than he wanted to, and he had to throw it with much more arc than he wanted to. And as a result, he was inaccurate with the toss.
So we'll see the first punt of the day for Jacksonville. Ryan Giratano is out to punt on fourth and four. Cherry back to return. He'll have to run for it. It'll bounce at the 27. Take a Jacksonville hop. Still rolling inside the 15, inside the 10 now. And it'll be down at about the 7-yard line. That's a 55-yard punt for Ryan Giratano.
Boy, the Hens are awful lucky that he didn't have the green light for the fake that time. Nobody guarded the gunner. The Delaware coaching staff on the sideline had a conniption that time, trying to grab their attention. Had he snapped the ball, just flipped it out there, not only would it have been a first down, it would have been at least 25, 30 yards. Expect Jacksonville, A, to keep an eye on that in the future, and B, Delaware to talk about that on the sideline.
Delaware backed up a bit. They'll start this drive on their own 7-yard line, down by 7, 7-0, 2:42 remaining in the first quarter. And we'll see Rankin again, back-to-back drives for Blake Rankin. Wes Hills is a single back behind him, double tight end set. And Rankin awaits a snap from Brody Kern, a starter last season who missed the spring. Rankin goes to Hills. Hills a burst of speed, gets him past the line of scrimmage, past the 10 and down at the 12-yard line. So a pickup of 5 on first down for Hills.
Well, that's impressive. 5 yards, single high safety that time. 8 guys all within 5 yards of the line of scrimmage. 1 safety back, 2 corners on the edge, and Delaware still blocks it up, hat on a hat, and find a little crease. And, of course, as we've talked about many times, Hills doesn't need all that much space. He kind of creates some of his own as well.
Tyler Havener in on the tackle. 2nd and 5 ball on the 12-yard line for Delaware. Rankin is the quarterback. Under center he goes. We see Randolph come in to spell Hills. Check that. Hills is back. Randolph also in the game. And Rankin going to roll out. Going to his right. Throwing downfield. Looking for Cherry. And in coverage, it looks like that one might have been intercepted. No, they're going to say Delaware came up with the football. That's the signal at the 45-yard line of Jacksonville. They were wrestling for it. And Cherry strong-armed the Jacksonville DB. Let's send it down to Michael Atrase, who had a good view.
Guys, so listen up. Whenever the defender and the offensive player both catch the ball, both have possession, most of the time they are going to give that to that offensive player.
You're right. Ty goes to the receiver. I think they're going to overrule this and maybe call. Oh, is there a flag down back behind the play? The officials are discussing. We just saw the replay. That was not a tie goes to the receiver. Michael's absolutely right on the rules. Deontay Cherry's back was on the ground with no hand on that football whatsoever. He rolls over on top of the defender and ties him up almost like you're watching a basketball game.
Holding. Number 17 on the defense.
There was a hold against Jacksonville. They're going to decline that penalty. And what a play by Deontay Cherry, the sophomore from Lancaster.
You're so right about that, because even if it was a good call or a bad call, you know, reasonable minds can agree to disagree. It was still one heck of an effort play by Cherry. It would have been really easy for him to give up on it and say, tough throw from Rankin. We'll get it back next time. Cherry did not quit on the play. No whistle blew. Keep going. See what you can do. And, boy, is the Jacksonville staff irate right now.
We almost saw the first takeaway for a Jacksonville defense that had 30, fifth in the nation a season ago. Instead, it's 1st and 10 for Delaware at their own 45-yard line. Rankin giving to Hills, going outside, cutting it back in at the 40, down at the 39-yard line. With 1:25 and ticking in the first down, 7-0.
I think one of the things that makes Wes Hills so impressive as a back, we've talked about his ability to run both inside the tackles and outside, but it's the combination of shiftiness and balance. You don't see that very often. His ability to make a guy miss and then find a way to stay on his feet as it looks like he's falling down. It's almost the FCS version of Barry Sanders, the way he does that. It really is. That's high praise, but it's kind of true.
Offset eye with Eric Patton in the ball game on 2nd and 4 from the 39 of Jacksonville. It's Hills again who gets hit low and dives forward to the 37-yard line. And it's going to be 3rd down with 44 seconds left in the first.
Big hit by Dallas Jackson, came in from his safety position and just filled the hole. And I don't care how big you are, how strong you are, you're not running through Dallas Jackson when he's in that type of position. I think this is probably two downs to get 2 yards, assuming you don't have a minus play here if you're Delaware.
Delaware going heavy. Patton in the game, Yoakum in the game, Whaley is there. An I form. Hills is in the backfield on 3rd and 2 from the Jacksonville 37. 3 behind Rankin now. It goes to Hills. Hills driving forward and picks up the first down to the 32 of the Dolphins. Tackle made by Grady Redding. And that'll do it for the first quarter of action. Jacksonville scores first. It's 7-0 after one. You're listening to 94.7 WDSD and HSRN on Sirius Satellite. Your PNC Bank timeout score after one. Jacksonville 7, Delaware nothing.
Where's the place to go for fresh homemade foods? I'll tell you where. Nutter's. For 62 years, we've been making Newark's best sandwiches and subs. If you haven't tried our award-winning crab bisque, then you've definitely missed out on what else is on the menu? How about our customer favorite, homemade chicken salad? Where are you going to get homemade chicken salad these days? I'll tell you where. Nowhere. Why is our food so good? We actually care about what you eat. Check us out at MyNutters.com and pick up a quart of bisque and make your mama happy.
Brought to you by State Farm. No matter where you are in life, we can help you protect what matters most. Find your agent at StateFarm.com.
The International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers Local 313 features the best trained and most skilled and productive electricians in the entire state of Delaware and Cecil County, Maryland. Our electrical contractors are ready to provide you the most competitive and all-inclusive quote for your next electrical project. Call 302-328-0773 today or visit IBEW313.org to get a list of electrical contractors who will provide you with the unsurpassed electrical service you require and deserve.
At Domino's, choose any two medium two-topping pizzas, pasta in a dish, sandwich, cheesy bread, or eight-piece wings or specialty chicken, and both are just $5.99 each. Visit Domino's.com.
At Glasgow Medical Aid Units, the doctor is always in and ready to see you quickly. With locations in Glasgow, Christiana, and Middletown, a new unit will be opening on the Star campus across from Delaware Stadium in October. Save time, save money, get well.
Delaware fans, this football season, National 5 and 10 on Main Street in Newark is stocked with all your favorite Blue Hen gear, including Under Armour, Champion, Adidas, and more. Online at National5and10.com.
Welcome back to Delaware football on 94.7 WDSD.
We are back at Delaware Stadium. Jacksonville up 7-0 to start the second quarter. Delaware now going towards that packed student section. And it'll start with Rankin and shotgun and Deontay Cherry in the backfield. Now he joins three other wide receivers on the left. Gets the screen. Cherry at the 35. Picked up right away at the 32-yard line. That's going to be a loss of one for Delaware to start the second quarter.
Well, the Hens had been playing with such success downhill. They tried to spread the field. The clock never started there, by the way, here in the second quarter. I wonder at what point the officials will notice it. There's not been a bang-up opening period for the Zebras so far. But they try to spread the field. I think they're trying to loosen up the Jacksonville defense. There's just too many bodies, too close to the line of scrimmage. Delaware is executing at a real high clip running the football right now, and they're still having to work awful hard to pick up 4, 5, 6 yards a pop. If they don't find some sort of a passing game, you know, you might be able to run the ball against Jacksonville, and Delaware's good enough. They'll run the ball against a lot of teams on their schedule this year. There's going to be certain squads you're not. You have to be a little more balanced than Delaware was in that first quarter, obviously.
First quarter stats, Rankin 3 of 4 for 47 yards. Hill 6 carries, 25 yards, 4.2 per carry. Rankin will go under center, second and 11 from the Jacksonville 32-yard line. Hill's behind him. They pitch it to West. West at the 30, has a lead blocker, and down he goes at the 29-yard line. It'll be third down and long. And again, Matt, we're seeing Delaware getting behind the sticks a bit.
And now a young quarterback's going to have to probably make a big throw. You know, it'll be interesting to see with this play call how much faith they have in Rago, how much they think his range goes, because you could also try to run it, see if you pick it up, surprise Jacksonville, worst case scenario, pick up 5, 6 yards and make it a more manageable field goal. Depends how much you, A, trust Rankin, how much, B, you trust Rago. And I think Dave Brock's going to take a timeout to think a little bit more.
He's going to take a break. We'll take a break with him. Your PNC Bank timeout scorer, Jacksonville 7, Delaware nothing in the second.
you have a check to deposit but are too busy to get to a branch? No problem. Del One Federal Credit Union has mobile deposit available from your smartphone or iPad. With this feature, you can take a picture of the check and deposit it using the Del One mobile app. That's right. Use the Del One mobile app to check account balances, pay bills, locate a branch or ATM, make a person-to-person transfer.
7 WDSD and by downloading the iHeartRadio mobile app. And as always,
go Hens!
Any of our convenient branch locations throughout Delaware or visit del-1.org for more information. Deposits are federally insured by NCUA.
This is Dr. Michael Axe. First Aid Orthopedics has award-winning physicians in more than 10 locations throughout the area to better serve you. Call us at 731-2888.
Diamond State Coins and Currency is the place for liquidating your coins, jewelry, flatware, and other valuables. Visit dscoins.com and take the Diamond State Challenge today.
You're listening to UD Football on 94.7 WDSD.
Welcome back to Delaware Stadium. Season opener, Delaware taking on Jacksonville. 13:49, second quarter action. Big play coming up here. Third down and 8 on the Jacksonville 29-yard line. The starter, Blake Rankin, in the ballgame as the quarterback in a passing down for the transfer from Rutgers.
Wouldn't be a bad idea here, maybe some sort of a wide receiver run with Jamie Jarman. I know they wanted to get him the ball with some opportunities or a screen draw to Wes Hills. The defense is certainly going to be looking for it. It'll be tough to get 8, but you want to make sure you come out of this drive with at least 3 points.
Jarman split out near side right. Rankin is the quarterback. Hills is the running back. Trey Brown to the left of Rankin. Cherry in the slot, right side. Third down and 8. Here's Rankin. Looking right. Throwing right. Open is Cherry. Makes a man miss at the 20. First down picked up inside the 15.
3 points, 3 points. That is a back foot anticipatory throw by Rankin. Good job surveying the field. Looked the safety off to the middle. Went back to the right. Threw that ball as Cherry was coming out of his break. Could not have thrown a more accurate pass than he did that time. Big, big conversion there from Delaware.
That was a confident throw by a player playing in his first game as a collegiate ball player. Offset eye as Patton comes in. Hills is the back on first and 10 from the Jacksonville 14. It's Hills looking for a hole. Spins off of a tackler and falls backwards at the 6. What an acrobatic run by the junior.
How did he take 3 steps almost parallel to the ground at a 45-degree angle in reverse? That was incredible. He got turned around at the line of scrimmage on an arm tackle. You do not arm tackle Wes Hills. And then somehow fell forward and had so much momentum, he almost somersaulted another couple of yards.
Hens will stay in the double tight end set. Patton also in on second down and 2. It's Hills again, running right this time. And he can't spin off the tackler this time around. Stood up at the 6-yard line. No gain on second and 2.
Boy, Jacksonville sold out that time. Eventually, if you're Delaware, the play action is going to be there. But with the way Wes Hills was running the football, you understand why you want to take a shot and try to pound your way in. But Trey Barnes, kamikaze, right through the center gap. And Hills almost met Mr. Barnes before he had the football in his hand.
Third down and 2 for Delaware. 12:06, second quarter. Jacksonville leads 7-0. Whaley and Yoakum in the game, as is Patton. Hills is the running back. Hills gets the football and tried to get away from one of his own players and ended up fumbling the football inside the 10. Jacksonville picked it up, and a turnover for Delaware in the red zone.
Well, I don't know, to be blatantly honest, when that ball came out. Hopefully they'll show a replay. They do. They put it up on the screen. Wells got drilled and was going to be short of the first down. It was the second man in as Wells was, or as Hills was a little loose with that football. He let it get away from his body, and Trey Barnes yet again, Johnny on the spot, scooped it up, started the other direction.
The play started as it looked like one of the guys in blue got in the way of Hills, which made him try to cut back. And from there, Jacksonville was able to poke it away. 30 takeovers as a team, a season ago for Jacksonville. That's the first of the game, and they stopped Delaware in the red zone. First and 10 for the Dolphins, up 7-0, 11:50, second quarter. Bell will start in the gun as he has most of this ball game, and they'll give it to the back, who's stopped at the 14-yard line by the captain, David Tinsley.
You know, you have to give the credit on that last play to Dallas Jackson. Jackson was the man that again filled the hole from his safety position, and Hills got hit pretty hard. If you're West Hills, though, your first priority has to be ball security in that spot on the field. You have to make sure you come out of there either with an opportunity to go for it on fourth down or with points. He tried on second effort, reached the ball out, and that's when it was knocked free.
Second down and nine, ball on the 14. Here's Bell, going to throw this time, or at least looking to do so. Nassib giving pressure, but he dumps it off at the 10, up to the 15, now 20-yard line. It's Tinsley again in open space this time. It's Jamal Ajma who caught the football and makes it third down and short for the Dolphins.
Rattray tried to run vertically down the field that time, see if he could get the safeties off and then come with something short up the middle. But Delaware had it covered up the seam, and then everybody else just flowing to the football underneath. Really good job, and again, good tackling for the hand.
Bell now 10 of 16, 115 yards. And it's third down and two for Jacksonville, up 7-0. Nickel defense for Delaware. Jackson showing pressure up the middle. Bell is the quarterback, takes the snap. Pressure comes from Nassib. Now Bell being chased. Here comes Jackson, and he throws it away with Jackson on him. That should be a penalty.
He did not get that ball to the line of scrimmage. Has to be a flag. Has to be. Oh, that's terrible. You have to get that ball to the line of scrimmage. There's no receiver within 10 yards of where that ball landed. He pirouettes and throws it to nobody in particular. Had no clue where he was. He's even if he's outside the pocket, the ball has to go to the line of scrimmage. And it came 5 yards short of the line of scrimmage. Wouldn't have been a safety, but it would have been a spot foul at the two. And it would have been great field position for Delaware. Instead, it's probably going to be decent field position for the Hens.
You're absolutely right. Line of scrimmage was back at the 21-yard line, and you gave him 5 yards shy. That was a good 10-yard shy of the line of scrimmage. Instead, a punt opportunity for Jacksonville, getting it off cleanly and calling for the fair catch is Cherry at his own 44-yard line with 10:22 remaining in quarter number two, a 35-yard punt. Hey, it's time to introduce a brand new feature this season, the Blue Hens Radio Restaurant of the Week. And I don't think there's a better way to start it off than with Newark's oldest family-owned establishment, Nutter's. In a world of pre-made factory food, it's hard to...
FH Club for details.
Customers come in daily for homemade chicken salad, crab cakes, and crab bisque. The crab bisque is my absolute favorite. Stop by this local landmark and experience the high quality that has kept Nutter's going for 63 years. Visit today at 1219 Nottingham Road in Newark and visit mynutters.com.
Boy, when I got out of college, my wife and I would race to Nutter's to try to beat it closing. That place makes the absolute best sandwich shops. You're so right about that.
We're excited to start out that new feature with Nutter's, a local landmark. You're absolutely right. Great food there at Nutter's. Delaware with the football back down 7-0. They just got stopped in the red zone. A fumble given up at the 14-yard line by West Hills. Back to Jacksonville. Offensively, Hills averaging 2.9 yards per carry, ranking 4 of 5, 62 yards.
Those numbers, of course, though, a little bit misleading. That 40-yard pass came on the controversial call. But if you're Delaware, the third down throw from Rankin, I think, gives you a little bit of confidence, although now Joe Walker's turn, because I think it looks like the answer has come. They're going to go quarter by quarter. And if a quarter ends with the offense on the field, you get to finish your series out. And so now it's Walker's opportunity. Rankin was not bad. They didn't give him many shots to throw the football. Didn't really make any mistakes, though, when he did throw it. And we'll see what Walker can do now.
Walker, the redshirt freshman from Philadelphia, has it first and 10 at his own 45. Fakes the pitch, rolling out, throws at the feet of Jalen Randolph, nearly intercepted. It was Grady Redding who was there in defense, and he was pressured by Terrence Bryant.
That wasn't a bad play by Walker. He just rolled right into a blitz, a safety blitz that time on the edge. And Walker actually did a good job to show some poise. You know, you could have seen him throw that ball in the air as he was trying to throw it away. He tried to throw it at the receiver's feet. That was a freak of nature effort from Redding. I don't know how he got his hands on that football. That was a bullet into the ground that time. He was trying to short hop that at Whalish.
It'll be second down and 10. Some quickness showed by Walker to elude that pressure. And trips to the right side. Walker, pressure coming again. Hit as he throws, and a little too hard to grasp for Deontay Cherry. back at the 42-yard line.
Yeah, he got to throw a catchable football, but in Walker's defense, he had a defender absolutely bearing down on him as I think that was T.J. Jenkins that time, the big defensive tackle who was just all over Walker, hit him right in the chest. And if you're Walker, two snaps and two times just getting drilled, you're thinking, boy, this college game is pretty tough, man.
They didn't hit me like this at MLK in Philadelphia. Now third down and 10, still at the 45 in their own territory, 10-11. Jacksonville showing blitz here in the second quarter. Walker going to tuck at the 45 to the 50, outside in Jacksonville territory, but he's pushed out well shy of the marker.
Holy smokes! He got a lot closer than I think you would have anticipated. He's a couple yards shy, but that play was bottled up. That looked like it was going to be 4 or 5 yards. You would talk about Dave Brock discussing the electricity of Joe Walker with his legs. It's really hard to judge in scrimmages and in practice because you're not going live. Nobody can hit him, so it's hard to gauge. The defender's not really running full speed his direction. That kid's got a different gear. You can see why Brock was so high on him coming out of high school.
Absolutely right. That speed we just saw a moment ago, outstanding from Walker, although they only get 8 yards on the drive. Anderson in to punt this one away. His first one was a touchback. Bryant chasing this one near the sideline, and it'll be inside the 20 for Eric Anderson. They'll mark it at the 12-yard line, and for Anderson, a 35-yard punt, but good positioning by Anderson that time.
Something he excelled at a season ago, that directional punting. So strong at it, both when he's trying to pin them back and also when he's kicking the ball deep. He's as good as kicking it to an angle and pinning a returner with an extra defender using the sideline as anybody in the nation. And that's why I still think if he can get a little bit better from where he was last season and just keep developing, he has a chance to be a next-level punter. He is really that good.
Absolutely right. Certainly the best at this level of college football, and you could argue at any level as he continues to develop at that punter position. 9:36 remaining in the first half. Jacksonville up 7-0. First and 10 for the Dolphins, and Cade Bell will start out of shotgun. Empty backfield. Five wide for the Dolphins. The lefty throwing quickly to Jones on the slant at the 19-yard line. Makes a few Delaware defenders miss as he wiggles his way up to the 24. That's a first down on the first play of the drive.
That's a throw Cade Bell did not have in his repertoire when they came to Delaware Stadium a couple of years ago. You want to talk about slinging it and with some velocity.
And now the Dolphins want to go fast on first down and 10 from their own 24. Bell again has some time, stepping up in the pocket, throwing at the 30-yard line. It's caught by Damian Strange. Down he goes at the 35. And the tackle that time made by Tenny Adewusi.
You know, we don't watch Jacksonville all that often, obviously. Sometimes you watch Cade Bell and you're like, just stay in the pocket. There's plays to be made. But that's clearly what he does, and he makes it work. It is kind of a lot of moving parts almost immediately, but he's effective with it.
Another first down for this high-powered offense. Nearly 500 yards of offense per game a season ago. They'll put it on the ground this time. And first contact comes at the 36, but dragging the defender to the 40. Yard line is the back, France Quadio.
I think we got an injury. A helmet came off that time. That's good news for Delaware. The back has to come off the field as Bryant has to check out. But if you're the hands, the bad news there was first contact, and Bryant just kept moving his legs. You don't want to see him get an extra 3-4 yards after contact, especially with the way Jacksonville's had success spreading you out. On second and short, it opens up pretty much the whole playbook.
Jamal Adjama comes in as the running back on second down and 4 from the Jacksonville 41-yard line. He stands next to Bell. Balance set. Two wide receivers on both sides for Bell. Ball on the near side hash. 8:17. Second quarter action. And Bell takes the snap. Rolling to his left. Looking downfield. Pumping, dumping it off to Adjama. And he's pushed out of bounds at the 50-yard line by Teddy Adewusi, the freshman from New Jersey.
Well, Delaware did a pretty good job defensively that time. Bell just beat him with his legs. He extended the play, and then another one of those flips almost looked like a game of beer pong the way he sent it over the top that time, headed towards the sideline. Just flipped it over the linebacker. Delaware fitted on the zone perfectly. They passed the tight end for the linebacker to the safety. Nobody open.
Under 8 minutes to go in the first half. Bell being pressured this time by Grant Roberts. Has to throw it wide for the intended target, Strange, near the Delaware sideline. It'll be second down and 10 at the 49 of the Hens.
See, the difference between this Cade Bell and the one we saw 2 years ago, that was still the throw he made. He almost likes to jump more than he likes to step into the throw, but his arm is so much stronger now. The ball gets there quicker. Last time we saw this Jacksonville team, those were floating ducks and balls up in the air that Delaware was turning into turnovers. They're not this time around.
Two wide receivers to both sides of Bell on second down and 10 for the near side hash. Bell talking to his offensive lineman, goes back into shotgun form. And Jama changes from left to right, and now Bell throws a dart to Andy Jones. Slits by a tackler at the 45 and gets first down yardage to the 39-yard line. The tackle was made by Ryan Torza in the secondary.
Brought Anthony Jackson on a blitz that time. Great cut block by Abjama. That allowed the seam to throw that ball through for Kate Bell.
And the Dolphins continue to pick up the pace. Back in shotgun form is Bell on first and 10 from the 39. Throwing near the sideline. And he had a man, but it was dropped at the 25-yard line. That pump throws Tenny Adelusi. His man, Matthew Passagiata, had the ball in his hands and couldn't haul it in.
Boy, that's a ball you got to catch. That was a perfect throw if you're Cade Bell. And if you're Delaware right now, you might have to stop watching Cade Bell. Just pay attention to what you're doing defensively in the secondary. You get caught ball watching, he's going to make you pay.
7-0 is the lead for Jacksonville. 7:30 second quarter. Bell gives to the running back. It's Quadio, who has not a whole lot of room against that big defensive line of Delaware, to the 38-yard line. And John Nassib, the 6'7 sophomore from Westchester, PA, made the stop.
A good job by Nassib, set the edge there, and Hollerman came in to help from the middle. Gang tackling so important if you want to be more secure tacklers, which Delaware has done. Now, though, can you get off the field? You do your job on first and second down, got to finish the job on third.
Jacksonville 3-5 on third down today. It's third down and 9, under 7 minutes left in the second quarter with a 7-0 lead for Jacksonville. Bell out of shotgun, two wide receivers to each side, ball in the middle of the field. On third and 9, here's Bell dropping back, throwing down the field, looking for Jones. It touches his fingertips, but he can't haul it in. Ray Jones in coverage, and it's fourth and 9.
Mark Doe, too. Give him some credit as well. Both of those guys. Jones coming over from his safety position. Really good job on closing speed for the true freshman. And then Doe underneath, running step for step. Just didn't leave much of a window there for Cade Bell.
And with the ball at the 38-yard line, we'll see the punt unit quickly before the punt. Let's send it down to Michael Atanasa.
Now, guys, on that last third down play in the first quarter where they gave up that long third down, which led to the touchdown, they went three down, but they went zone. This time on third down, they go man coverage, and you see it pay off.
Punt on the way from Jacksonville, booted out of the end zone, and it'll be Delaware football with 6:35 left in the second quarter. Yet to score are the Delaware Blue Hens, down 7-0. And I believe we'll see Joe Walker, who had a three and out on his first possession.
Yeah, give Joe Walker an opportunity here to be point blank honest. I mean, the offensive line, which has been the strength of this team. And honestly, not even just the offensive line, the play calling that time, the rollout rolling right into a blitz. Walker has to have the chance to at least look. If he's going to throw the football, they try to give him a safe pass in the flat on his first snap. The blitz kind of blew that up for Delaware. Then on the second play, he was able to make something happen with his legs. But if you're Walker, sure would be nice to see him plant his back foot once and see what he's capable of.
We're going to see Thomas Jefferson for the first time come into the football game to start this drive on the 20-yard line, down 7-0. Walker back in. As the quarterback, he goes under center. And Jefferson, the single back behind him. Thomas Jefferson's first carry is a good one across the 25 and to the 27-yard line, a 7-yard pickup for the freshman from Prospect Park, New Jersey.
And they had Wes Hills in there as well. He was set up wide in the slot on the left. That was who they bluffed the end around to. Two linebackers went his direction, opened up all kinds of space up the middle, and Jefferson is a good, quick, between the tackles runner. Had a nice burst of speed to get a good first down gain.
Jefferson redshirted a season ago, but was on the team as the number 4 running back. Tight ends trade from left to right. Second down and 3 for Delaware from their own 27. In motion goes Hills. They'll fake the give to him. Again, it's Jefferson running diagonally to the right, and he gets to the 30-yard line. 2 carries, 10 yards for Jefferson, and a first down.
And again, hit at the 28, spins forward. And that's what all three of these Delaware backs are capable of. The ability to get yardage after first contact, and if defenses are going to be as aggressive against Delaware and flooding the box the way we've seen Jacksonville in the early going, backs are going to have to break tackles this season. It's certainly going to be something they have to have, and they're capable of doing it.
Trey Brown and Deontay Cherry stacked to the far side of the field. Walker under center. He'll keep it on the ground, though. And to the 33-yard line goes Jefferson for his third straight carry.
Pretty good job by Jacksonville that time. No movement on the right side whatsoever. They tried to use the athleticism of Brody Kern getting out there on the right. He was pulling. And Jacksonville just flat out beat him to this spot. Jefferson had nowhere to go. He tried to be patient, see if he could set his blocking up. Did not have the chance. Three Dolphins arrived before he could get even to the line of scrimmage.
Now Walker will move back into shotgun form on second down and 8 from the 33. Jacksonville blitzing with Bryant on the left side. They go to Jefferson again. 4 straight for the freshman. And he's looked good this time to the 37-yard line. Third down and manageable for the Hens. Looks like our first Newark urgent care injury timeout as there's a player down for Jacksonville. It's Armani Sampson, the junior from Tampa Bay Tech.
Hopefully, and it looks like, especially the way the athletic trainer comes out to treat him, it's a cramp. It is not overwhelmingly hot. Could be worse in early September. Probably hotter in the broadcast booth, to be honest, than it is down there in the field. But it isn't cool, I'll say that much, and it's humid. The good news is the storms, which were in the vicinity, look like they're going to miss us, and we should be all right. But it doesn't make it any easier to play football down there, especially at the tempo both of these offenses are trying to operate at. Poor Scotty's trying to ease his way into the season. It's coming fast and furious, huh, buddy?
Got a lot of new guys. I'll tell you, I love the design of the new uniforms. They look awesome. They do not do us any favors with that font on the jersey.
Yeah, the flare cut of the numbers certainly can be difficult to read. It's not the Delaware jerseys that are the problem, though, man. It's Jacksonville. They're gray jerseys with light green numbers. It is impossible. I mean, it's like it must be how people that need glasses feel when they're trying to look regularly.
After the injury to Sampson, it brings up third down and 4 for Joe Walker. Low snap, rolling to the right. And he hits his man at the 43-yard line. It's Cherry, his third catch. Another first down on this drive for Delaware. And the first completion of the career of Joe Walker.
And a good one there. Moving pocket, accurate throw. Got it out on time. And by the way, we were talking in the pregame show and really all summer long. Hey, what is Delaware going to do at wide receiver? They're awful thin, aren't they? They don't need any other wide receivers. Deontay Cherry has been the whole show so far.
Cherry had a heck of a freshman campaign. 35 catches, third most by a UD rookie in Delaware history. Now first and 10 at the 43. Jefferson still in as the back. Patton comes in as the fullback. And Walker will give it to Jefferson. Starts left, tries to cut right, gets to the 45-yard line. Brought down by Malik Slater.
Again, they're trying to find something. They don't seem willing to throw the ball on first down because they want to stay ahead of the chains. So in order to try to keep that defense from overcommitting to clog the middle, they fake the wide receiver end around again. That time it was Trey Brown running to the edge. And at least slows down the pursuit of the defense. Just didn't open it up enough for Thomas Jefferson.
Cherry comes back in. Patton to the sideline. Cherry split out to the left side. Ball in the center of the field. Second down and 8 from the Delaware 45-yard line. It's Jefferson. Again, he's been a workhorse on this drive. Gets to the line of scrimmage. Third down and 8 coming up. 3:14 second quarter. Delaware yet to score. Down 7-0.
Tell you what, though, with the way Delaware's running their offense and then with the efficiency that Cade Bell's been throwing the football, it's limited the number of snaps. Even at the feverish pace we've played this game at points over the course of the night, you look at the clock and there's already about 3 minutes, now under 3 minutes left in the half. If you're Delaware, you're shortening the game certainly this way, and this would be a huge conversion here and go in and get something positive before intermission.
Extra receiver in, Owen Tyler, the freshman in the slot for third down and 8. Ball at the Delaware 45. Shotgun snap comes to Walker. Here comes pressure. He eludes it. Tucking, running at the 45. Midfield cuts it at the 45. Flag is thrown out of bounds at the 40. Joe Walker making it happen with his feet.
Terrence Bryant thought he had him lined up. He thought he was going to tattoo Joe Walker. Walker stopped on a dime and cut back as a face pass called here by the official will add 15 on top of it. And Bryant went to reach out. He didn't find air, but he found only face mask. He found none of Joe Walker's body, which is what he thought he was about to blow up. That was an incredible first to cut back after he was giving some ground, and then that stop on a dime. I'm telling you, this is next level quickness from Joe Walker. Now, clearly he's going to have to develop as a passer. You can't do it all with your legs, but that kind of electricity, oh, he could be fun to watch over the next 4 years.
He certainly can, showing the speed, showing what he can do with his legs. And Delaware approaching the red zone. Ball on the 25 of Jacksonville. Give is to Randolph, who comes into the ball game. Hills was in there as well. And to the 21 goes Randolph, approaching the two-minute mark in the second quarter.
And clock should not be a factor now for Delaware. They have all three of their timeouts. They're right at the edge of the red zone. You could still take your time. You could still run the football. Just be wise about clock management here, but it should not hinder what you want to do over the final 100 seconds of this opening half.
Delaware has been in the red zone once today. Approaching it here, they fumbled the football away the first time they got down there. Randolph is a single back. Walker sends Cherry in motion on second and six. Screen pass thrown to Cherry. Cherry's going to throw it himself. Randolph grabs it and scores! Jalen Randolph from Deontay Cherry, and the packed student section going nuts. Delaware on the board in 2015.
What an adjustment to the football by Jalen Randolph. That was an interception. Cherry threw it up for grabs, underthrown. Great call, but better coverage from Jacksonville. Randolph just wanted it more. He went up and got it as Sampson waited back on the football, thinking he was almost going to make a fair catch interception. And Randolph cutting in front of the defensive back, using his hands to go high and bring in the first score of the season.
Anderson will hold. Rago's kick is up. And through your PNC Bank timeout score. Delaware 7, Jacksonville 7, 1:20 left in quarter number 2.
Welcome to State Farm, Mr. Murphy. What do you have there?
Metal detector. You mentioned you were going to comb through my auto policy to unearth some hidden savings, and I figured you could use this.
Actually, I just meant I'd give you our discount double check. I'd dig through your policy and see if there's some discounts you could be taking advantage of. We find more than just nickels and dimes.
Oh, that sounds great. Oh, there must be a lot of metal in your desk.
It's a metal desk.
Always looking for the discounts you deserve. That's State Farm's discount double check. Call 1-800-STATE-FARM and get to a better state. State Farm.
It's Value Day at participating Shell, Exxon, and Dash-Ins throughout Delaware. Look for the blue and red signs at participating Exxon and Shell stations offering savings on fuel.
IBEW Local 313 features the most skilled and productive electricians in the area. Visit IBEW313.org to find contractors who will provide you with the unsurpassed electrical service you deserve.
Welcome back to Delaware Football on 94.7 WDSD.
All the debate about who's going to play quarterback for Delaware, Walker or Rankin, and it's Deontay Cherry with the first touchdown pass of the season, 22 yards to Jalen Randolph, who took it out of midair and got Delaware on the board. It's tied at 7.
The first ball caught by a Blue Hen this season other than Deontay Cherry was thrown by Deontay Cherry. If you can't love that, then you don't love football.
McLaughlin kicks it away. And from the 6-yard line, Jacksonville will take it to the 10, 15, 20. And brought down in space by Wes Hills. Who else on special teams? Let's go down to Michael Attanase on the sideline.
Now, guys, Cherry is one of the better receivers on this team. You'll see him catch a lot of screen passes and take it the distance. But to catch a screen pass and throw a touchdown pass soon after like that, with that much ease, that was a great play. Randolph did an even better job going up, what we call mossing that DB, taking that ball out of the air, snagging it like it was his own, like going up for a rebound. That was just awesome. Trickery in the red zone is something you definitely have to look for.
I love it as well up here. You know, we got a glimpse of that in the spring game. Deontay Cherry threw a 30-yard touchdown pass in that spring game and does it when it counts tonight against Jacksonville. Still a minute 16 left in the first half, though. Jacksonville with the football. Bell in shotgun form to start this drive on his own 19. Screen pass is caught by Amoni Williams. He gets the outside wrapped up at the 25-yard line, and it's Ray Jones who makes the tackle.
If you're Delaware defense right now, the one thing you got to do a little bit better job of is staying on your feet. Jacksonville's throwing a lot of cut blocks on the edge, and they're having success getting Delaware's defenders on the ground. Good job, though, by everybody else to rally to the football. They had Jackson's back that time.
Three down linemen for Delaware on second down, and four to go for Jacksonville. Here comes David Tinsley, and the captain gets the sack.
as a busted play. I think it was supposed to either be a wide receiver screen on the outside or a handoff to Bryant. Cade Bell got up hot under the collar. Great job by Tinsley not to give up on the play. Yep, that was supposed to be a handoff to Bryant. I'm not sure what happened.
So this is what a healthy David Tinsley looks like. It's been a while since we've seen the senior from Florida healthy, but he's had a heck of a first half.
Smart by Jacksonville here just to run the clock down. And if you're Dave Brock, you're content to let him do it. Take this momentum into the locker room on what was a tough first half, to be honest, for your offense. And yet you're in a tie game and with all the energy on your side.
Timeout taken by Jacksonville with 24 seconds remaining in the first half. Don't go anywhere at the break. We'll have a quick chat with head coach Dave Brock. Our interview presented by Rufo Associates. Visit RufoLaw.com, and we'll have Matt Pensick back in the studio. It's our Blue Hens halftime report presented by International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 313, and its local contractors. But you're right, Matt. Momentum on the side of Delaware heading in to the locker room.
And the best part about this, I think it's been a relatively entertaining second quarter after a little bit of a slow start. There is just a monumental student section here tonight. The end zone seats are filled. One section on the far side, two sections on the far side, part of the third. This game's been good enough that I think there's a pretty good chance these folks stay and are a part of the second half, and that's good for two reasons. They've been a factor in this game, and B, remember, trying to grow that Delaware brand back. You got to get the students involved to do it. Hopefully tonight is a step in that process.
And a great effort by the marketing team at Delaware to be out there on campus making sure the students are here at the game. And a draw play on third and seven as we continue play. Bell on the tackle as it goes to the 25-yard line. Now a timeout taken by Delaware with 18 seconds left. Might as well, as it'll be fourth down for the Dolphin.
That's a West Hills timeout. If I get the ball to West Hills in space on a punt return and see what happens, if I'm Dave Brock, I'm going to do it too. You know what? If he breaks one, great. If not, we'll probably take a knee. We'll run the football and see if you break a big run. And worst case scenario, hopefully you go to the locker room in a 7-7 tie. But why not take the chance? It shows trust in Hills that he won't do anything silly on this punt. And if he grabs it and can do something great, you also have had success in the past blocking punts. Remember, that's one of the big parts of Delaware's bread and butter, special teams-wise. During the Dave Brock era, they blocked as many punts as anybody in the conference.
After the timeout, fourth and one for Jacksonville. Jacksonville had the lead almost this entire first half, but late, Deontay Cherry with the 22-yard touchdown pass to Jalen Randolph. And pressure coming on the punt, getting it off, and it's Cherry just going to let it roll from the 35 inside the 20 and now down inside the 10. Still rolling towards the 5-yard line. No return for Delaware. 4 seconds left in the first half. A 67-yard punt. A nice bounce for Jacksonville. Delaware took a shot, called the timeout if they would have been able to return it, just as you described, but nothing to lose there. They'll take a knee and head to the locker room.
Yeah, they brought 10. They went for the block that time. They had Cherry back. They weren't setting up the return. They figured rugby-style kicker, if he runs right into somebody coming from the edge, you get a good jump. What's the worst thing that happens? Remember the JMU game a couple of years ago? Late in the first half, the block punt really kick-started that comeback from Delaware. I think it was West Hills, actually, that blocked that punt. They blocked two in that second half against JMU. So it's been something you've had success with. Take the chance. And the best part of it was, if you rough the kicker, who cares? It's a 15-yard penalty. They still have it on their own side of the field with like 5, 6, 7 seconds left in the half.
4 seconds left, tied at seven apiece. We'll hear from Coach Brock before he heads into the locker room. Walker under center, and he will end the first half of action with a score tied at seven apiece. Coach Brock coming the way of Michael Attanasi. It's the first half interview presented by Rufo Associates. Visit RufoLaw.com. And Delaware, tie score, played fairly well in the first half with all things considered. New team, new quarterbacks, and some fireworks late in that second quarter.
I think Walker brings an extra dimension to the offense. Not that Blake Rankin played poorly. He didn't. But Walker's electricity, I think, forces Jacksonville to defend more.
And Coach Brock making his way over to Michael Attanasi. We'll send it down to Mike, who's got Coach Brock.
Let's go, baby. We got to own the game up front.
How you doing, Coach Brock? Stagnant first half.
actually stagnant first quarter, per se, for the offense. Second quarter, we started picking it up. We started moving the ball. Trick play right here, a great touchdown. What seemed to be the difference between the first quarter, second quarter with the offense getting the ball moving?
Well, I mean, we had the ball down inside of 20. We got a bad penalty that cost us the field position and some points there. Inflicted things, and Joe Walker made a terrific play on a scramble. And then, you know, we got the double pass. Playing our tails off on defense. We had a lot of young guys running around the first series. They were, I think, a little bit of anxiety, nerves, whatever it is. We've settled down and forced a punt every other possession. You know, the game's going kind of how I thought it would. You know, we're going to try and control the ball, be physical, play really, really physical defense, and you know, we just got to do a little better job offensively, getting points when we have the ball inside of 20. You know, 1-for-3 is not going to do it.
All right, thank you, Coach.
All right, babe.
All right, thanks, Mike and Coach Brock, for his time before heading into the locker room. At the half, we're tied at 7. It's a season opener here at Delaware Stadium. We'll take a break. When we come back, it's the Blue Hens Halftime Report presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 313, and its local contractors. Your PNC Bank timeout score at the half, 7 apiece, Delaware versus Jacksonville.
Taza Coleman made an instant mark at Delaware as she captured the 200-meter dash title in the CAA Championships in May. A native of Middletown, Delaware. She also placed second in the 400-meter relay and fourth in the 100-meter dash to cap an outstanding performance. And in women's golf, Delaware Junior.
Also, Andy Slane is our
women's golfer to win the title. The Temecula, California native did so with a CAA record score of 67 on the final day of action. Andy could not be here today, so she's competing for the Blue Hens at the Penn State Invitational this weekend. Let's have a great big University of Delaware Fight Blue Hens round of applause for our 6 UD winner in Spring Conference Championships 2015. We take pride in your accomplishments and wish you the best of luck in the future. Ladies and gentlemen, performing part one of the show based upon the music of Andrew Lloyd Webber's Phantom of the Opera. With an encore of the University of Delaware.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to a new season of Under the Lights, driven by Chevy. I'm Scott Klatskin here with head coach Dave Brock. Another year about to get started, and I guess we start with, how's your summer? It has a different meaning when you're a football coach than just around the office, but how has the summer gone for the Blue Hens?
It's gone great. You know, we had everybody here and working out and taking classes, so I think we had a great summer portion of the program and really catapulted us into training camp, and we've had a great training camp, really excited about where we are, what we're doing, and really looking forward to 7 o'clock Friday night with Jacksonville coming to town.
Yeah, it's coming up quick on us, Jacksonville, 7 o'clock at Delaware Stadium. We're going to use this show to go through the offense, go through the defense, talk a little bit about the Dolphins. So let's start with offense. Everybody's talking quarterbacks. Let's talk quarterbacks. Blake Rankin, Joe Walker, the two seemingly going to be splitting some action on Friday night. Talk to me about how that decision came about.
Well, I think they both had really good training camps. They've worked. You know, both have had some really good points in training camp and done some great things. And I think really they both earned the right to play. I don't feel like one separated the other. And I really want to give them an opportunity to do that. I think it's the best decision going forward for the team. Now we're in the process of just trying to figure out how we're going to play them, whether we do it by series, whether we do it by a quarter, first and second quarter, and then let it play from there. But I think both of them have played well in camp. Both of them have earned the right to play. And I really look forward to them going out and playing well for us on Friday night.
I think everybody's excited to see those two. It'll be the first time in quite some time that a quarterback that has not taken a snap previously will start the opener for the University of Delaware Blue Hens. No matter who the quarterback is, who they're handing the ball off to is probably the most important part of this offense. Two guys coming back in Wes Hills and Jalen Randolph, and then some younger guys that look to make an impact even more so than last year, like Kareem Williams and Thomas Jefferson.
Yeah, thrilled with the running back position. I mean, we've talked about that since last year. You know, that really is the ideal position for us in terms of what we want to look like as a program. You know, we feel like we're four deep, and really, you know, with moving Patton over, we feel really good about what he's going to bring in terms of being a blocking back and adding some physicality. But, you know, certainly Wes Hills and Jalen are very, very good football players, very productive players, over 1,500 yards at the position last year. And you know, both of them can play in the passing game. Both of them can protect. So they're complete players. Really looking forward to seeing Thomas Jefferson play. You know, he's a guy who had a great redshirt year. He's had a great offseason, a great training camp. You know, so he'll line up as number three, you know, and then Kareem Williams is here, and you know, we're going to hold it on Kareem a little bit and see where we are with the other three first, and make some decisions down the road. But we're excited about that position. We feel like it's going to be a really, really good position for us.
Possible duo like Hills and Randolph with Williams and Jefferson moving forward, if that ends up being the case for Williams sitting out a year, to kind of catch up with Jefferson's eligibility.
Yeah, that's absolutely the hope. I mean, again, you want to be in the business of collecting good players, and you know, I think competition more than anything creates you know, guys who play at the highest level that they possibly can, whatever that is. And you know, that certainly has been a position that has done that.
Now, moving on to the guys that will be blocking for the quarterback and the running backs, this offensive line, guys are big, guys are strong, guys are back. Four guys returned that started last year on that offensive line. Ben Curtis, one of the seniors, providing leadership to an otherwise rather young but experienced offensive line.
Yeah, excited about that group. You know, with four guys coming back, have game experience, they've been coached. You know, we have four redshirt scholarship players who are in the mix now, and then four true freshman scholarship players. So, you know, we've certainly, you know, put in an incredible amount of investment in that position. You know, Benny Curtis is certainly the leader as the senior. Everybody else who's back, Jake Trump will start for us at left tackle. We feel great about him. Mario Farinello will be the sixth guy. If needed, he'll go in, and you know, we'll shuffle some people around. But we feel really good about that position, and we got young guys in Jethro Pepe and Krakowski on the tackles that are the backup guys that are working hard and kind of growing up. Those are the redshirt guys that are really doing a good job and that are in the mix in our top eight.
Love the size you got on that offensive line, though, guys. Get bigger and bigger each year, it seems, on that O-line. And finally, for the offense, that wide receiver position, you got Deontay Cherry coming back. Third best season from a receiver by a freshman last year for Cherry, so you know you're good with him. Who are some other names that we'll be seeing at that wide receiver spot?
Well, we're certainly hoping Trey Brown, who's a redshirt freshman, we've kind of tagged him as a guy we wanted to hold last year and coach, and you know, he's had a great training camp and has really done a good job, and I think he's prepared to do a great job for us this year. Jamie Jarman, Ricky Bell, you know, Jamie moved over, he's done a great job. Rick's done a good job. Vinny Papali will play. You know, so when you look at them and you add in the tight ends, Brandon Whaley and Owen Tyler and Yoakum, you know, I think we got a good mix of guys in the passing game, along with the running backs who are good players in the passing game. So I think we're going to have to be versatile and move things around a little bit and you know, really depend on you know, the running game to get us going. And then, you know, I think if we can run the ball, we'll be able to do a lot of things.
All right, that's the offense. We'll take a timeout. When we come back, we'll talk about the other side of the ball for University of Delaware as they get ready to take on Jacksonville this Friday night. You're watching Under the Lights.
I am forgiving every ounce of my blood, every breath in my lungs. Won't stop until I'm free, not to know. I am forgiving however long it takes. I'll go to whatever lengths. It's gonna make me a monster, though.
Stay connected with the Blue Hens on all social media outlets. Follow at UD Blue Hens on Twitter for score updates, news, and everything Delaware sports. Check out at Hens All Access to see what it takes behind the scenes to bring you Delaware athletics. Interact with the University of Delaware Fightin' Blue Hens on Facebook to get to know the athletes and hear about events offered to Blue Hens fans. And take a look at UD Blue Hens on Instagram for game times, game finals, along with throwbacks of old Hens and promos for future Hens.
Welcome back to Under Lights, driven by Chevy. I'm Scott Klatskin here with head coach Dave Brock. We talked a little bit about the offense. Let's flip it over to the defense now. And a lot of new names will be on the defensive side, but one that's very familiar, setting a freshman record for sacks last season, was Blaine Woodson, the CAA Defensive Rookie of the Year. You got to be excited to have him back, not only for this year, but three more seasons.
Yeah, no, it's exciting. I mean, he obviously is going to be a dynamic player. We're hoping that he'll be one of the elite players, not only in the CAA, but in the nation this year, and really from a production standpoint, lead that defensive line. From a defensive line standpoint, that's our most experienced group. You know, we got David Tinsley, who's back, you know, from a couple injury-riddled seasons. Vince Hollerman, who's been a really good player here for a number of years, and Josh Plummer, who's back. Really three of our seniors are on the defensive front, so we're counting on them doing a great job. John Nassa, Blau Nichols are back. Cam Kitchen, a true freshman, will play. Grant Roberts, who played a lot of football for us, will play. We anticipate probably using 9 guys minimum on the defensive line and rolling people through and really trying to make sure that we're as fresh as we can be and play as hard as we can possibly play up front.
I had a lot of fun watching John Nassib play last year. Tall guy. I think he would lead the conference in blocks if he played for Monte's team, I believe. But a lot of balls batted down from him and a lot of talent on that defensive line. Now, at the linebacker position, you had some youth playing last year. Now, all of a sudden, those freshmen that were playing as true freshmen, redshirt freshmen, are now the starters as sophomore. Talk a little bit about that core.
Well, excited. I mean, Charlie Bell will be in the middle and has done a great job, has had a fantastic camp. Anthony Jackson on the weak side, he'll really do a great job. He's really put himself in a position, I think, to be a dynamic player after playing a couple hundred snaps for us last year. Really, that group, the competition that was created within the linebacker group, probably helped the guys who were here more than any other position, because now you have Jalen Kendall and Larry Spears, who have really played very little football for us, and as the freshmen kind of went past them last year, I think they had to make a conscious decision to kind of, hey, let's go compete and play and lift and run. And Larry Spears has been the star of camp. I mean, he's the most improved player. It's not even close. We're really looking forward to watching him play and going out there and getting after it. And then we'll play 2 of the true freshmen in the game Friday night, which we're excited about. And we'll probably play anywhere from 7-8 linebackers in the game. And we feel good about it.
A lot of players going to get into that game against Jacksonville. Certainly on the secondary side of things, probably 7-8 guys might see some action in that secondary. And a lot of them playing in their first game on Friday night. Talk to me about that secondary and who you've got out there.
Well, you got Justin Watson, who's back and has done a great job for us and is a really competitive player. Had a great camp and really is becoming a leader. Ryan Torres at safety. Maurice Harley, he's done a good job. Mark Doe is back there at corner. But all 4 freshmen will play. Ray Jones will start at 1 safety spot. Tenney will play a bunch. Casey Hinton will play a bunch at safety. And Nasir Adderley will start at 1 of the corner spots. So we feel good about them. They're competitive kids. They've come out. They've played. They've competed. They're going to get what they've earned. Really looking forward to watching them play. I'm excited about seeing it and what they can do. I think it's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's got to be exciting for a coach. You coach these guys all summer long in the spring, and you kind of know what they're capable of doing, and now it's just a matter of them going out and seeing. As a coach, is that one of the most exciting parts of starting a new season? You taught it, now it's their turn to execute it?
Yeah, you want to see how they react. Probably more important than anything, you want to see how they react to adversity. It's usually pretty easy if things are going your way and everything's okay, but when the ball gets thrown over your head or you miss a tackle or whatever, those really are the defining moments in terms of whether or not you're going to have a really good team or not. You don't really find that out, I don't think, in training camp. I think you're more likely to find out what you're going to do and how you're going to be when you're down in a game and you battle back or you give up a big play. How do you handle it individually? Do the other players pick you up? So really, Friday night, I'm looking forward to seeing, how we compete as a team, what we're able to do, and I think we'll be able to make a pretty good assessment after that.
And then last but certainly not least, when you've got an All-American punter and probably the best punter in the nation. I'll toss that probably out. The best punter in the nation in Eric Anderson. Let's talk some special teams. You have the veteran in Anderson, and then you'll have a kicker who'll be lining up and kicking that ball for the first time as a collegiate player out there on Friday.
Yeah, no, I mean, obviously, Eric's, we think he's the best punter in the country. He's done a great job for us and an unbelievable player off the field as well. But we feel like he's the best player in the country at his position and a real weapon in terms of field position and so forth. Rago is going to be our extra point field goal guy and he'll do a great job. He's statistically been fantastic in camp. But again, the lights are on. The stage is a little bit bigger. He's got to go out and make kicks. You know, everybody asks, how do you feel about the kicker? And, you know, the reality is you feel great if he makes it and not so great if he doesn't. But, you know, we feel good about where he is and what he's done and our ability to assess that. He's done a great job. Kevin McLaughlin kick off for us and he handled that great. His leg's stronger. It's really live. And you know, we feel really good about special teams. It's all hands on deck. We'll play everybody, you know, in terms of anybody on the team's up for special teams. So we're looking forward to it.
I'm always torn when I see Eric Anderson come in. I'm sad because we're punting, but I'm excited to see Eric Anderson boot the ball like he did last season.
Yeah, I'm not excited to see Eric, but we love Eric.
That's true. Very true. And we love this team going into the 2015 season. It all starts on Friday night against Jacksonville. We'll take one more timeout. When we come back, we'll tell you about the Dolphins playing at Delaware Stadium for the second time in three seasons. Back in a moment.
Takes one person to save a life.
And you can make a difference. It's painless, it's easy, it takes 15 minutes. We will make a difference in the future of these people that have these diseases.
Join CAA Football for Be the Match Saturday. You too can get in the game and save a life.
It's a chance to save a life. How great is that?
For more information, visit caafootball.com.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
This is Hens All Access. You're watching Under the Lights, driven by Chevy. We talked about Delaware on offense and on defense. Now let's talk about the team that they'll play on Friday night. Jacksonville University Dolphins is the team that Delaware faced two seasons ago. Your first game as head coach of Delaware, a victory for the Blue Hens. Different team this year, but one thing remains the same is their quarterback, Cade Bell, an all-Pioneer League quarterback last season, threw for a school record yards. He's a very big weapon for that team, and he's the coach's son.
Yeah, he's done a terrific job. You know, he's a very efficient player, threw for over 3,000 yards. Very veteran player, makes good decisions. He really does limit your opportunities to take advantage of him. So we're going to have to do a great job. They have some fast guys on the outside and good perimeter players, two really good running backs. One was a 1,000-yard rusher last year. They were a 9-win team.
Line five penalties. So of their last three.
Quarterback Blake Rankin on the carry. Brought down by 26, Josh Sellerian. Ball's at the 32-yard line, third down and three. Jalen Randolph on the carry. Stopped by 7, Dallas Jackson, and 17, Terrence Bryant. Gain of 4 yards. First and 10, Blue Heads. Flag in the play. From the 31-yard line, first down and 15. Blake Rankin's pass complete to 33, Jalen Randolph. Brought down by 98, Joshua Gilmore. Loss of 1, second down and 16. Flag on the play. From the 25-yard line, second down and 21. Jalen Randolph on the carry. Brought down by 23, K.J. Jenkins. Ball's at the 29-yard line, brings up a third down and 17. Blaine Rankin's pass incomplete. Intended for 33, Jalen Randolph. Fourth down and 17. On the punt for Delaware 49, Eric Anderson. Thank you.
A 38-yard punt for Eric Anderson before Jacksonville takes the field. Let's send it down to Michael Antarase.
Guys, Wes Ellis seems to have some kind of hamstring injury. He's down here on the sideline. The trainers are trying to stretch out that hamstring. I'm not sure when he's going to go back in. I think that's why we saw a lot of Randolph that last drive.
Eagle eye from Mike and a big developing story. Wes Hills, such an important part of this attack. Can't afford to be without him if you're Delaware in this second half.
That was our Newark Urgent Care injury report from Michael Antarase, and that could be huge. We'll take a look, or Michael will keep his eye on Wesley Hills as the second half continues. Score tied at 7, 10:39, third quarter, and Cade Bell and the Dolphin offense back on the field. The running back is Bryant next to him. Bryant, an option at the screen pass, but Bell throws opposite side of the field to an open man at the 41-yard line. And an 8-yard pickup on first down. Catch was made by Strange on the far side, and tackle made by Watson.
Pretty good job by Watson to get out there and make that stop in space. That being said, Bell bluffs left. The whole Delaware defense went that way. Isolated Watson on the outside right.
Second down and one for Bell. Ball at his own 42-yard line. Shotgun snap. Looking towards the left. Throwing, and it's short for Prince Gray. Skipped it to him and incomplete.
Cade Bell changed the play. We heard his dad, the head coach, Kerwin Bell, talk about he is the FCS Peyton Manning. Actually, I don't think he used the term FCS. He just flat out called his kid Peyton Manning-esque. But sometimes when you're going to operate an offense at the line of scrimmage, got to make sure everybody's at the same page. His two receivers on the near side both put their hands in the air. They had no clue, and they ran wrong routes, and that was a big play opportunity gone by the wayside, and they don't know the play again here.
Now third down and one. Still 11 seconds to get the playoff for Jacksonville from their own 42-yard line. It's Bell in shotgun form. A running play up the middle, and it was Larry Spears who stood up the running back, but all they needed was a yard, and they got that to move the sticks.
Good tackle by Spears. Just good drive block on the left side by that Jacksonville offensive line. No chance for Spears. By the time he got to the back, he was already at the sticks.
First and 10 for Jacksonville. 11th first down of the game for the Dolphins. They averaged 24 a season ago per game. Under 10 minutes, third quarter. Bell, moving pocket, slings it high over Gray's head and into the Delaware sideline.
He just threw it end over end. He's getting to look more and more like Peyton Manning every time with those wobbly ducks there.
Is that a shot at Peyton Manning?
Never. They're effective wobbly ducks when Peyton Manning throws them. A little less effective there for Cade Bell.
Bell now 16 of 28 after that incompletion. 173 yards for the senior all-pioneer, one of the greatest quarterbacks in Jacksonville history.
Don't accuse me of taking a shot at Peyton Manning. My wife won't talk to me for a month.
That's very true. Second down and 10, ball at the Jacksonville 44-yard line. Four wide receivers, two to each side. Ball on the far side, hash for Bell. Quadio is the running back. Bell throwing, sidearm, caught in Delaware territory at the 49, far side of the field, shy of the sticks. And Nasir Adderley with the tackle. That was Brian Burnett, the sophomore, with the catch. Third down and short for the Dolphins.
As an 18-year-old, coming up and making that stick, and that's the second time he's done it. He's all by himself on the outside. He got help after he held him up, but Adderley's got to make that tackle, or not only is it a first down, it's probably another 10, 15-yard gain.
Empty backfield on third down and three for Jacksonville. Cade Bell is the quarterback. Trips to the left side. Two to the far side of the field for Bell, the senior. Taking the snap. Looking. Running. Throwing. And it's incomplete. High for his intended target, Damian Strange. Justin Watson was all over him.
You know, we talked about in the first quarter, Cade Bell just moves his feet so much and was making things happen. He threw 108 yards in the first 15 minutes of the game. He only threw for 56 yards in his second quarter. And I'm telling you, if he just stays in the pocket and forces Delaware to cover a little bit more, it seems like there'd be some opportunities. He takes off before there's pressure. I don't call him happy feet, but he's certainly not still in the pocket.
On fourth and three, Jacksonville punting. It bounces at the 17-yard line, and Jacksonville's getting some nice hops on those punts. That one will go inside the 5-yard line, and that's where Delaware will take over on offense with a score tied 7 apiece, 8:44 remaining in the third quarter, a 45-yard kick for Jacksonville. And a reminder, this game on WDSD and on HSRN. We'll talk a little bit more about that when we come back. We'll take a timeout. Your PNC Bank timeout score, Jacksonville 7, Delaware 7, 8:44, third quarter.
Delaware fans, don't forget to stop by National 5 and 10 on Main Street in Newark. They have tons of new styles of Blue Hen gear, including Under Armour, Champion, Russell, and Adidas. Plus, State of Delaware souvenirs, clothing, and more. Get everything you need to cheer on the Blue Hens this season with the largest selection and the best prices. In stock now. The place to buy your authentic University of Delaware and State of Delaware souvenirs and clothing is National 5 and 10. Main Street in Newark, online at national5and10.com. Go Hens!
I have 15 seconds to tell you about the best place to eat in Delaware, Nutter's Sandwich Shop. 63 years of serving Delaware's best homemade sandwiches and subs. Delaware Today's editor's choice for best crab bisque. MyNutters.com.
It's Value Days at participating Shell, Exxon, and Dash-Ins throughout Delaware. Look for the blue and red signs at participating Exxon and Shell stations offering savings on fuel.
Welcome back to Delaware Football on 94.7 WDSD.
As we went to break, I mentioned we are on Sirius Satellite HSRN. Heritage Sports Radio Network has partnered with the CAA, and now you can hear CAA games on Sirius XM, or you can download the HSRN app. HSRN and the CAA creating college sports memories together. We are excited to open up the season of HSRN coverage. Delaware starting this drive on their own 5-yard line. And rolling out is Rankin, throwing on the run. A tight spiral for Trey Brown, but too low. He had a dive for it, and it falls incomplete. That's the first time Trey Brown has been a target tonight. It fell short at the 18.
That's not really that bad a throw, though, by Rankin. Moving pocket to the right. He's got to put that low to the outside. He leaves that ball up. All of a sudden, a defender can come back, cut in front, and get the interception. A little bit too far out in front, but that's not horrible ball placement there from Rankin.
And a good sign is Wes Hills now in the huddle. Michael Attenrausse noticed a possible hamstring injury for Hills, but we see him now as a single back. He's in the end zone on second down and 10 for Delaware. Tight ends trade sides from left to right. And in motion goes Owens Tyler. They give it to Hills, and he's stopped by that Jacksonville defensive line right at the line of scrimmage. It'll be third down and 10 under 8:20 and ticking in the third.
The old proverbial brick wall that time for Wes Hills. Good to see him back. Good to see him healthy. Nowhere for him to run whatsoever.
And now Randolph in the game on third down and 10. Cherry and Jarman join him out there. A lot of substitutions in and out for Delaware throughout. A lot of guys playing for the first time in their career.
Can you convert a third down and long? Delaware has only been able to do it once all game.
Rankin in shotgun form, his feet at the goal line. Cherry goes in motion from left to right. Rankin talking to his offensive line, and they have to use a timeout, do the Blue Hens, because the play clock was winding down. No, they didn't get it off. It's going to be an illegal procedure against Delaware.
Wow, the Hens coaching staff was calling for a timeout. I thought the field judge had signaled it. But it's a good decision not to take the timeout. Timeout's more valuable than the yardage on where you are on the field. It costs you 2.5 yards. And the timeout in a tie game midway through the third quarter, I'd rather have the timeout personally.
Yeah, half the distance of the goal penalty from the 5-yard line makes it third down and 12 for Rankin, who stands at that W in Delaware in the end zone. Third down and long. Rankin, screen pass goes to Randolph. He's got to get out of the end zone. Barely does as he's tripped up at the 1. Good pursuit by Jacksonville. And it'll be fourth down and very long for the Hens. Anderson will punt out of the end zone.
You just can't operate in the type of confined space that Delaware has tried to tonight. And so much of it, I think, is the lack of depth at wide receiver. Deontay Cherry has turned in a yeoman's effort trying to do it single-handedly. They're just soaked in, and they're missing that dynamic
stretch the field threat. And as a result, Jacksonville's defense is teeing off on the underneath stuff.
A lot of pressure on Joe Fortunato to get this snap into the hands of Anderson. He does cleanly. Anderson boots this one away, sends Terrence Bryant running backwards. He catches it at the 47-yard line, sheds one tackler. Justin Watson gets him at the Delaware 41. That's a 50-yard punt for Eric Anderson. But Jacksonville, great field position to start their second drive of the second half. 6:32, third quarter action, still tied at 7 apiece. An 11-yard return for Terrence Bryant.
It's still good field position, Scott, but that is one heck of a kick by Anderson. That's a one-step boot. I mean, he had 10 yards of real estate between him and defense that time. He's got time to catch it, one-step, kick it away. He boots it 50 yards in the air with some hang time. Got his mates reasonable time to get down the field and limit that return as well.
He's certainly a weapon for this Delaware team. But now, Cade Bell and the offense of the Dolphins on the field at the Delaware 41-yard line. Pistol formation, Bryant behind Bell, and they'll go to Bryant. Running to the left, cuts it on Torza at the 40, a missed tackle by Delaware. And to the 34-yard line goes Bryant. It was Delaware's Josh Plummer who made the stop.
Yeah, Torza was there. He was in pretty good position. They got penetration that time from Plummer as well. Plummer forced him wider than he wanted to go. Torza just caught a little flat foot, and he cut back to open space.
Pass to Giada in on second down and 3. The fullback for Bell out of shotgun. And a whistle. And it'll go against Jacksonville. False start.
Hey, you know, it's opening day. And we have seen a lot of unforced errors. The U.S. Open's going on up in Flushing Meadows. And this has kind of been that type of day for both of these clubs. Every time they've gotten a little momentum going, that sloppiness of the first game of the season has crept in at bad times for these clubs. And second down and short opportunity, maybe run play action, throw the whole kitchen sink Delaware's direction, turns into a second down and a lot longer here for Jacksonville.
Seventh penalty against the Dolphins today. Second down and 8, 5 minutes, 38 seconds. Third quarter, scores tied at 7. Bell rolling out of the pocket, looking down the field, has an open man at the 30, passes caught, and down at the 24-yard line. And the tackle made by Spears. Catch made by Chris Skukula. Dolphins going fast. Pistol formation. Approaching the red zone at the 25, first and 10 for Jacksonville. Moving from right to left is Skukula. And they'll give to Bryant. He shifts in the backfield. Good pursuit by Delaware and a tackle for loss by the Hens. That's Bilal Nichols, who's been active in today's game.
See, I thought the right tackle moved that time early. It looked like Mark Botkin got a little bit of a head start, and Nassib still beat him, which is an awful good sign when he's getting driven back to be able to fight off the block and crush that right side of Jacksonville line.
Two wide receivers to the right on second down 11 from the Delaware 26-yard line. Play action. Bell pumping. Has some space to run at the 25. He trips a bit as Jackson was in pursuit. And down at the 22, it'll be third and long for the Dolphins.
That was the most comfortable Bell has looked in the pocket that time. He dropped back, hit his back foot. He climbed the pocket. He kept his eyes down the field. But Watson, great coverage. And how about Ray Jones, the true freshman from Delaware, staying in the middle, not biting forward as the quarterback came up. Let your teammates take care of that. You keep your deep responsibilities. That's something Delaware has struggled with in years past.
Delaware showing some pressure. Third down and 7 for the Dolphins. Approaching 4 minutes, third quarter, tie score at 7. Ball at the Delaware 22-yard line. Bell being pressured, and down he goes! It's big Blaine Woodson!
That forces the field goal. That's bulldog determination that time from Woodson. He took an outside route, and then as Bell tried to climb the pocket, just collapsed forward. Both the end and the tackle went to the outside. Bell thought he had some space to move up, and it collapsed in a hurry.
This will be a 42-yard attempt for Brandon Bear, who's 13 of 18 career. Hold is down. Kick is up. Has the distance. And it's through. Jacksonville leads 10-7. That's your PNC Bank timeout score, 3:15, third quarter.
chicken, roast beef, corned beef, ham, or roast beef and jalapeno. Five fun sandwiches for $1.29 each. Arby's, we have the meat.
Hey, it's Flo, and this is my impression of an automatic boat naming machine.
Name number one, yeah, buoy, spelled B-U-O-Y, ha ha ha. Name number two, peer pressure, get it, P-I-E-R, see what I did there. Name number three, great boat insurance from Progressive at a great price. Maybe a little bit long-winded, but nevertheless true.
Progressive Boat Insurance. The coverage you need starting around just $8 a month. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. $8 monthly premium excludes fees and taxes and is not available in all states.
Discover why thousands of people choose American Spirit Federal Credit Union. You can find more information online at AmericanSpirit.org. That's AmericanSpirit.org.
You're listening to Blue Hens Football on 94.7 WDSD, Dover, Wilmington.
Make your current banking situation simply better with Dexday Federal Credit Union. At Dexday, you receive better service, better rates, and an overall better banking experience. Dexday invites you to open an account and discover truly free checking with no minimum balances, no monthly fees, and access to over 55,000 ATMs. Call Dexday Federal Credit Union at 302-571-0522 or visit dxsta.com. Jacksonville finishes a six-play, 16-yard drive with a 42-yard field goal by Brandon Bear. He ties the school record with his 14th career field goal made.
Talked earlier about the big play not being there for Delaware and the Hens having to meticulously work their way down the field. Well, Jacksonville's kind of been dealt with the same thing. The Hens are tackling, taking away the big play, and Jacksonville hasn't executed all that well either thanks to the defense.
Ray Jones back to return, bobbles it in the end zone, and he'll take a knee. He wanted to take that out from pretty deep. It's almost a good thing that he did bobble it, and that way he was forced to take the knee. Delaware will get the football. 3:15 remaining in the third. Jacksonville up 10-7.
I mean, it is a light years difference, though, from what we saw in years past. It's starting to get better second half of last season, but I thought it was way better so far tonight in terms of the tackling. We haven't seen more than three or four real missed stops, missed opportunities at tackles so far in this game. Last year, it seemed like they were averaging 9, 10, 11 missed stops most of the year.
And it looks like Rankin coming back in. Walker had a good first half. Rankin, though, under center with Hills behind him to start this drive at the 25. Whaley and Yoakum trade from left to right. They're the tight ends. Now in motion goes Tyler, and he is laid out. Check it was Hills at the 25-yard line. No gain, but a big hit by DJ Howard.
Boy, that was a stick. They tried to run that speed sweep. Hills lined up as a wide receiver came in motion. He did not get the jump on the defense. Then he tried to cut back against the grain, and all he found was a turf. I mean, if Wes Hills was not feeling great earlier, that certainly isn't going to help his cause.
That was a big hit by Jacksonville with a three-point lead. 2:40 and ticking as both Randolph and Hills in the ball game. Randolph on the wing, ball on the near side hash, and Rankin gives to Hills, who changes direction and backs into a defender at the 30-yard line. That's where he'll be marked. It'll be third down and five for Delaware.
He is a tough son of a gun, isn't he? I mean, he was hit at the 28. He was stood up by a strong guy as there's an injured Jacksonville defender down there. And he had no leverage. His back was turned, and yet he still got low and somehow found a way to drive for an extra yard or two, as it looks like a cramp for Jacksonville.
And he hurt KJ Jenkins, who was in on the stop. That's our Newark urgent care injury timeout. Also gives us a chance to remind our listeners that it's Value Days at participating Shell and Dashin stations throughout Delaware every Monday. Save 10 cents per gallon off of diesel, 20 cents per gallon off premium on Tuesdays, and save 5 cents off per gallon on all grades of gasoline every Thursday. Download that Dashin app by texting WDSD to 55123.
And Jenkins is up, able to leave under his own power. And I got one for you. How about an opportunity to tweak Villanova? Delaware fans love that all the time. Last night, the Wildcats started their season. Couple CAA teams in action. Villanova was a 7-point favorite over an FBS team, which is impressive. Good for the league. They lost at UConn. That was a little bit of a disappointment for John Robertson, but the Villanova people were all over Twitter and just pounded their chests about being a 7-point favorite. That didn't work out as well as they had hoped.
And that a Glasgow Medical Aid Unit scoreboard update, as we'll update you all the time when Villanova takes an L. Third down and five. Big play here for Delaware. Down by three. 2 minutes left in the third quarter. And Rankin drops back the pass. Being chased. Being pressured. Turns around and heads to the other side of the field. He's got to get rid of it. And he does just in time as DJ Howard was all over Rankin as he ran to the east stands and back to the west before getting rid of it. And Eric Anderson back on the field to punt, fourth and five.
Tell you what, though, the one thing you do like about Rankin, you know where his eyes never left? Down the field. He had to spin around once or twice, maybe had his back to the line of scrimmage, but once he got righted again, the eyes went right back to his targets. Now, nobody popped open, but that was a yeoman's effort. Rankin, you can see why the coaching staff likes the way he runs the offense. It doesn't have quite the electric threat as a walker with his legs.
Anderson. Delaware lines up in the shield, punt, booms one on fourth and five, sending Terrence Bryant back. It rolls, probably would have taken some more hops if Watson didn't grab it at the 13-yard line. And Anderson showing off the leg, 57 yards on the punt for Eric Anderson. But Jacksonville with the football again, up by three. It's 10-7, 1:41 left in the third.
You don't want to beat a dead horse, but he just flipped the field.
Yeah.
With one swing of his legs, all of a sudden they're all the way backed up, and exactly what we were talking about early. Jacksonville's not running off all that many big plays, though. The two times they've scored, they've been long, sludge-it-out type of drives. The 10-play 90-yarder to start the game, excuse me, the 14-play 90-yarder to start the game, and then the last time they had the football, it was quite the effort from the Dolphins, 5, 6, 7, 8 yards a pop. So when you force him to go 87, you're in pretty good shape.
Ajima is the back. They've been swapping Ajima, Quadio, and Bryant. All three have played for Jacksonville on first and 10 from their own 13-yard line. And they fake to Ajima, rolling out his belt. Eyes downfield, but near him is Andy Jones, who is close to the sideline, but got 1 foot in at the 20-yard line. And a pickup of seven on first down.
It's almost as though Jones was surprised that Bell threw him the football that time. Bell is a guy, he's a riverboat gambler, and he always is looking for the vertical shot. I think Jones just kind of gave up on the play and almost wandered his way out of bounds.
Seventh catch of the day for Andy Jones, the senior, second down and three for Jacksonville. Bell back in shotgun four. Torres is showing pressure. He comes. They give it to the running back, and he hits a wall at the line of scrimmage. Three Delaware jerseys were there, including Bilal Nichols. And it's third down and two, approaching the one-minute mark in the third.
They are not moving Delaware's defensive tackles. We're talking about establishing the line of scrimmage. Delaware's doing a good job of that. And then Torza, who blitzed to the right, found a way to get back in that play to the left. That's a good job of playing to the whistle and helping, making sure you gang tackle and get the guy off his feet.
Third down and two. Ball on the Jacksonville 21-yard line. Bell out of shotgun. Ajima is the back to his left, and a false start against Jacksonville will make it third and seven. Eighth penalty of the day for Jacksonville.
That's the fourth time, Scott, that a Jacksonville wide receiver has false started. That time it was Gray, and Kerwin Bell might not have a working headset anymore. He just fired that thing about 15 yards up the field.
Obviously not pleased as the head coach of the Jacksonville Dolphins with all those false starts. But now third down and seven for Jacksonville. Some changes in defense for the hands as Ray Jones comes in. Three down line, the nickel package on third down and seven from the 16 for Jacksonville. And Bell has some pressure, steps up, room to run at the 20, 25, 30, 35, near the sideline and brought down in space by Ray Jones, but enough for a first down pickup from the senior quarterback from Fleming Island High School.
Mike alluded to the man coverage. It has helped Delaware defensively. They've done a better job isolating the wide receivers and taking away the vertical passing game. But they ran everybody down the field. Everybody's back to the line of scrimmage. Bell saw it, immediately took off. Easy first down.
New set of downs for Jacksonville. 10 seconds left here in the third. Could be the final play. And Bell rolling out. Flag thrown, maybe a hold. Bell was looking downfield, but threw it short to Andy Jones in traffic and incomplete.
Yeah, I don't think you have to say maybe. Ritterhoff tackled him on the outside. That was old-fashioned high school wrestling takedown there from Ritterhoff.
I'll tell you, you mentioned earlier, Bell throws some ducks, and one of these could be intercepted eventually. As he threw that one, it almost looked as it slipped out of his hands.
he never sets as he throws. I mean, even that time, he had time to stop, set up, and throw. Now, he should not have thrown that football. He fired it into a whole lot of traffic. But that's why the ball comes out of his hand so ugly sometimes. He's always on the move.
First down and 10, last play of the third quarter. And they're going to have an end around to Amoni Williams trying to turn upfield in pursuit. Delaware on the far side of the field was Cam Kitchen, the freshman. 19-year-old playing in his first collegiate game. That ends the third quarter of action with a score. Your PNC Bank timeout score, Jacksonville 10, Delaware 7. Fourth quarter football coming up.
Mom, Dad got burned. It's gross.
Grilling burgers and dogs?
I forgot the spatula in the kitchen.
So the grillmaster extraordinaire got burned flipping burgers by hand? Genius, honey.
Did I win a trip to Glasgow Medical?
Yeah, Dad, you're a real winner.
With three convenient locations, Glasgow Medical units are there for you. Open 7 days a week, 8 to 8, and every holiday, 9 to 5. No appointment is necessary. Plus, they accept most insurance providers.
Save time, save money, get well. Visit GlasgowMedicalCenter.com today.
Capriotti Sandwich Shop has catering available for all your tailgating needs. Order online at capriottis.com from locations in Newark, Cokesson, and Kirkwood Highway. And download the Capriotti's loyalty app to get free food.
Even big-time executives get Labor Day off. But at Executive Auto Group, we're working this weekend, including Labor Day, so you don't have to. That's right, we're making car buying easy at our huge Labor Day sales event with extended hours and, of course, great deals on that new or pre-owned car or truck you've been eyeballing. So this weekend, make an executive decision. Relax, have fun, and show up at Uncle Morty's cookout in the car of your dreams. Executive Auto Group, 11 great franchises. Visit executiveautogroup.com for details.
You're listening to UD Football on 94.7 WDSD.
15 minutes left in the season opener for the Hens. They're down 10-7. As we enter the fourth quarter of action, let's send down to the sideline. And Michael Attenrausa.
Now, guys, defensively, they've been going to man coverage, especially on long downs, and Bell can't find anyone open. They're doing a good job of covering these receivers. The D-line just has to make that tackle and get the quarterback on the ground.
Yeah, they've been trying to rush so far up the field, Mike, they've kind of gotten caught out of their lane, something I'm sure you would know about. How many times did your coaching staff stress to you the need to stay at home, not get caught too far
stay
up and let
in
the
your lane.
Exactly.
Second down and 17. I want to remind our listeners, you're listening on 94.7 WDSD and HSRN, the Heritage Sports Radio Network, on Sirius XM. They've partnered with the CAA. We love those guys over at HSRN. We're happy to be their first broadcast of the year. Second down and very long after a couple of penalties for Jacksonville. Second and 17 from their own 29-yard line. Pressure coming, and Cade Bell's going to go down. It was David Tinsley in on the sack, the captain, with his second sack of the day.
David Tinsley, the first solo captain at Delaware since Dan Mulhern back in 2002, and a guy who's been through so much over the course of his career, certainly a deserved honor, and he is playing not only like a captain, but one of the best players on the field right now, has been phenomenal so far tonight, both against the run and the pass.
Tinsley missed last season. After being injured in that Pitt game, glad to have him back. Third down and 23. That sets up for Jacksonville from the 23. Screen to Jones. Running room at the 30. To the outside at the 35. 40. Pushed out of bounds. Big pickup, but shy of the first down marker as Casey Hinton shoved him out.
They got 19, but fortunately for Delaware, needed 23. Broke contained to the outside. Good hustle, though, from Hinton to stay with the play that time. And make sure he knew exactly where he needed to go and just usher him to the sideline. Delaware first missed tackle we've seen in a while.
Jacksonville will punt on fourth and five from the 41. That's a good punt, sending Cherry backwards. He bobbles it at the 10. Delaware picks it back up, though. That could have been killer as Cherry never really set his feet. Mark Doe was there to slide in and recover the football. A 49-yard punt, minus two on the return, and Delaware backed up to start this fourth quarter, down by three.
Holy cow, did that disaster just get averted that time? If your Cherry got caught drifting because it was such a good punt, But at that point, if your feet aren't set underneath of you, you got to just get out of the way of that football. Fortunately for Cherry, Emin Smith inexplicably was diving at Cherry's feet. Had Cherry caught that ball, he would have easily made Smith miss. Not a good time to leave your feet. And the Hens, fortunately, did as Walker back into QB.
The freshman under center, Hills behind him, the single back, two tight ends in the ball game. First and 10, Delaware starts at their own 8-yard line. Walker takes it. They give it to Hills, running wide, trying to turn upfield, and does at the 15, 20, 25, 30. Makes a move at the 40, a stiff arm at the 45, and down he goes at the 47-yard line. The biggest pickup on the ground tonight for Delaware. 39 yards for Wesley Hills.
And I'll tell you what, a great job that time by Hills. He noticed that the end White got caught too far inside. He pinched too far, lost his contain. Wells went wide with it, and with his speed, that was an easy turn of the corner. And Jacksonville is fortunate Hills didn't take it to the house.
Bryant saved what would have been a 92-yard touchdown. First and 10 for Delaware. Randolph giving Hills a blow. No, Hills is in the game, goes in motion. He was lined up as a receiver. Walker going to throw downfield. It's over the head of Trey Brown at the 15-yard line. Brown had a step, but flags all over the place. Near the throw, it's going to be a hold against Delaware. What a throw by Walker. Too far down the field, but this guy's got speed. He's got an arm as well. The freshman playing his first game out of Martin Luther King High School.
Indeed. Unfortunately, not a lot of touch there. It wouldn't have mattered because Jake Trump called for the hold, but you got to put a little more air under that football and just kind of let your receiver run underneath of it. Walker had the opportunity. Again, it would have all been for naught because of the holding penalty, but tonight it has been very tough for Delaware's receivers to get behind anybody, and when you get that chance, you got to convert on it. But I like that they gave Walker the opportunity. I think you have to at least show it.
And remember, this is a very good secondary that picked off 24 passes a season ago to lead the nation. First and 20 for Delaware. And they give us the back. Hills, who had a 39-yard run moments ago. Down the sideline, he gets past the 40 to the 44-yard line. It'll be second down and long for Delaware, getting backed up a bit after that big play by Hills a moment ago.
Yeah, you're still off schedule, but you gave yourself a chance here with that 70-yard pickup. Second and 13. You don't need all 13 yards here. You're playing for 6-9. I mean, if you get 13, great. But 6-9 is that sweet spot where it turns it into a third down and manageable. Remember, at the pace Delaware's playing, you're starting to run down the number of possessions you're going to get. Probably about three left.
Delaware down by three. It's 10-7, 12:41, fourth quarter action. Second down and 13 from their own 44. Under center goes Walker. Play action. Has some time. Rolling. Pumping. Throwing behind Jalen Randolph at the 50-yard line. It'll be third down and long.
Walker opens up the opportunities, but he's a young kid. He just needed to stay with it. Jamie Jarvin came wide open on a post. Now, there was some pressure in Walker's face, but all was Jarvin open. He knew it down the field. But Walker, in his first collegiate game, hadn't been hit all camp long. I mean, that quarterbacks don't go live. That was what Dave Brock was talking about. How does this young guy respond to being live, respond to the opportunity to get hit? Can he stand in there and show the poise? And it's a lot easier said than done until you get some reps.
Randolph stands next to Walker in the gun on third down and 13 from the Hens 44. Here's Walker, shotgun snap. Pocket collapses. He's trying to wiggle out and cannot get past the pursuit of Malik Slater. And punt unit on again for Delaware after some promise showed on that first play. We'll see Anderson to punt things on fourth and 18.
Yeah, the silver lining here is you flipped field position. You went from backed up. Now you have a chance, opportunity to back them up. But you did have an opportunity that you let go. The holding penalty is certainly not helping the cause. And what are we talking about with Mike? Stay in your lanes. Jacksonville did it to perfection that time. Nowhere for Walker to escape.
Anderson gets this one away cleanly. Bryant back to return. Feet at the 20. He'll take it from there. Gets past one blue hand. And another now at the 30. Cutting it up at the 40. Another juke move at the 45. At the 50, he is brought down by Bilal Nichols, who was the last man back for Anderson. Big return for Terrence Bryant. 41-yard punt. 34 yards on the return. And Jacksonville in business to start this fourth quarter drive. 11:39 remaining. Up by three.
Nobody has heaped more praise upon Eric Henderson than I have. If you're going to try those directional kicks, the one thing, though, you can't do, line drive down the middle. It leaves your coverage units way too prone. No hang time, no opportunity to get down the field. He caught it with way too much ahead of steam, and it's too easy to make the first couple guys miss when they have the jump run in the other direction. That was just a low kick down the middle, and that can spell disaster for a team's unit. You have to get a stop here. Touchdown would be lethal with under 12 minutes to go.
Bryant is the back. Bunch trips to the left side on first and 10 from the Delaware 46. And the play clock runs out. That'll move back Jacksonville.
That's not very Peyton Manning-esque right there. That's a lack of awareness from Cade Bell. Now, some of that was on his coaching staff, to be quite honest. They were very late coming out onto the field. They kept them over there for a long time, but you still got to know where the clock is. It's got to be one of the first things you find when you come out if you're Bell.
First and 15 after the penalty for Jacksonville, back in their own territory now at the 49-yard line. Same set, bunch trips to the left side. Ball on the near side hash. Bell in shotgun form. Bryant is the back, and they'll go to Ulysses Bryant, who ran for 1,000 yards a season ago. He only gets 2 yards that time. Blaine Woodson on the stop.
But I tell you what, Delaware has just taken away Jacksonville's running game. Dave Brock, like not one, not two, but three different Jacksonville running backs seemed very concerned coming into the week, didn't he? Now, he said his team would be better tacklers, and he was confident that they could make some plays defensively, but he seemed worried about the running game. It's been no factor for Jacksonville tonight.
You're absolutely right. Only 60 yards on the ground for Jacksonville, a team that averaged 187 a season ago. Pistol formation on second down and 13. Bryant behind Cade Bell, who's in shotgun form. Here's the snap to Bell, the lefty, looking upfield, moves up in the pocket, nowhere to go. Brings it to the outside, throwing on the run behind his intended target. Diving for it at the 35-yard line. Officials yet to call it a catch or not. And it is a catch. An athletic move by Damian Strange, who had to go back and get it. And that's a 14-yard pickup on second and 13.
Boy, that thing had disaster written all over it, but Bell stuck with the play. And it was a catch, it looked like, on the replay monitor.
So now Jacksonville with 10:36 remaining, up 10-7 at the Delaware 34-yard line. Bell drops his mouthpiece, picks it back up, awaits the snap. One running back to his left, looking right side of the field on the slant. It's Strange again. Jones is there to make the stop at the 24-yard line. That should be good enough for a first down. And a player is down. It's Maurice Harley. That's your Newark Urgent Care injury timeout. That'll slow things up for this Dolphins team that's not very happy. They were quick to the line. They wanted to go fast. And the sophomore from St. John's College High School in Upper Marlboro is banged up.
That's a great throw by Bell. Had a small window, got it just over top of the linebacker. You want to talk about hitting a guy coming out of his break perfectly in the chest with some velocity on it. Bell, who was great that first quarter, I thought somewhere around average, maybe even a little bit below average here over the last two-plus quarters, but given good field position here, just made one heck of a play with his feet to buy time and pick up that 14-yard first down conversion, and then follows it up with a bullet. And now all of a sudden, if you're Delaware, they have 7 points all night long. This game is eerily similar to that Sacred Heart game last year, remember, where the Hens lost 10-7, couldn't muster much offensively. You fall behind by two scores, this is going to be virtually impossible to come back the way they have struggled to move the ball, particularly through the air.
Delaware 243 yards of offense so far. Jacksonville 304. Hens doing it 155 on the ground, 88 through the air, while Jacksonville 244 yards through the air and 60 on the ground. Harley comes off the field, and Delaware's defense back on the field after back-to-back first downs picked up. Bell to Strange for 15 yards and then a 10-yard pickup a moment ago. Clock approaching 10 minutes left in the ballgame as Bell goes in shotgun form. Ajama is the running back to his left. Far side hash. Bell throwing towards the end zone and over the outstretched arms of Andy Jones.
I was thrown to a spot that time, and Jones was just a little bit late coming out of his break, kind of rounded off that route as he was going to the back pylon. And I think that's exactly where Cade Bell wanted to put the football. Jones was just a little bit late getting there. Delaware, very fortunate he was. They were beat on what looked like a near-perfect throw. I mean, you designed that to go to the back flat.
Now second and 10 after the misfire. Ball on the Delaware 24-yard line in Bell in shotgun form. Ajama goes from right to left. Two wide receivers to the Delaware sideline. Bell looks that way, now coming to the left side. Plants his feet, being pressured, and just throws it away as Delaware was in pursuit. It was Josh Plummer as the nearest man there, but there was a couple of blue jerseys putting pressure on Cade Bell.
Again, he left the pocket. He didn't need to, and this time he ran left, and there were no receivers on the left side of the field, which makes it awful tough for an offense if there's nobody over there with you. I mean, he's going to have to throw the ball 30 yards across the field just to find an eligible receiver. Good decision to throw it away. And if you're the Hens, you can live with him leaving the pocket outside of a couple runs. Not much has happened outside of that first quarter when he's gotten to the outside.
Hens bringing the extra defensive back on third down and 10. Big play here for the Blue Hens. Ball on the Hens 24. Here comes pressure. Bell running. Slips out of his hands as he tried to throw the football to Andy Jones. Jones wanted a holding call. Won't get it. And it's fourth down and 10 for Jacksonville.
Now, he had a little bit of a case, but I think the official lets it go because it wouldn't have been any opportunity for Jones to pick up the first down. There was a bit of a clutch, a bit of a grab as he came over the middle. Good news is Harley was right back in the game. And he got physical defensively and got away with it.
Now, Bear on to try a field goal. He made one from 42. This will be from 41. Far side hash on fourth and 10. Bear gets this one away. And that one's through again. It's 13-7, your PNC Bank timeout score with 9:34 left in the fourth.
Diamond State Coins and Currency is a locally owned and operated company that has been purchasing gold and silver in North Wilmington for over 13 years. We set ourselves apart from other gold buyers by paying 20 to 50% more for your gold scrap jewelry, sterling flatware, coins, currency, and other valuables. Visit our website, dscoins.com, to contact us, read what others have experienced, or take the Diamond State Challenge. Conveniently located at 1705 Marsh Road, easy access off of I-95, open Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., or call us 302-478-9050.
Injured, hurt in a work accident, or in a car accident, you need professional legal help. Potter Carmine and Associates, a proud sponsor of the Fighting Blue Hens, can help with offices in Newark, Wilmington, and Smyrna.
Want to advance your full-time career? A UD part-time MBA may be what you need. The UD MBA offers unmatched online and on-campus flexibility. Move your full-time career ahead with a UD part-time MBA. Visit udmba.com for details.
Welcome back to Delaware Football on 94.7 WDSD.
9:34 remaining from Delaware Stadium. Opening game of the 2015 season, Hens versus Jacksonville. Jacksonville, 7 plays, 22 yards. They've just had great field position. Their last scoring drive was only a 16-yard drive that ended in a field goal. 41 yards off the leg of Brandon Bear, who's 2 of 2 from beyond 40 yards now. And the Hens will line up to return. And now if you're Dave Brock, you've got two guys, you've kind of been rotating. What quarterback do you go to during crunch time? Down by 6.
I think you stick with Walker because it's still a one-possession game. Maybe had it been a two-possession game, you might have to try to go back to Rankin. But I still think Walker frees things up with his legs, his ability to make plays. Maybe spread the field a little bit and go to the running game that way.
Hills back to return. Line drive kick from the 4-yard line, middle of the field. At the 10, 15 now, looking for some space at the 25. Good return for Hills. Gets upended as he gets to the 34-yard line. But Hills doing some damage in the return game. And with 9:28 left in the fourth, Hens down 6 with the football. Let's go to Mike Atenrase down on the sideline.
Now, guys, on third down, Delaware's defense has been going to a 3-down package, bringing the extra DB in. They've been doing really well playing man coverage. That time, they put people on the line. They blitzed. They wanted to put pressure on Bell. I think the defensive coordinator is getting more and more trust in his young DBs, and he's putting blitzes in to try to knock Bell off his rhythm.
Walker is the quarterback on first and 10. Ball on their own 34-yard line. Two tight ends in motion. And Walker will put it in the chest of Jalen Randolph, running wide at the 35. Stiff arm at the 41-yard line and pushed out of bounds by Armani Sampson. That's a good first down pickup. That's what you want if you're the Blue Hens with 9:22 left in the fourth down six.
That's a good jump cut that time by Jalen Randolph. He turned something into nothing. That play was designed to go off left tackle. He had to bust that way further wide than he wanted to, but found a little open space, turned the corner, and that's a huge difference. A 7-yard gain instead of two. Second down and short, something Delaware has not been faced with very much in this second half.
Grady Redding is the player down as we take a Newark urgent care injury timeout. Redding, in this contest, 7 tackles, all of them in the first half, 5 solo tackles for the junior out of Cocoa, Florida. He's an all-pioneer guy. He's been on the all-pioneer team a couple of times in his good career. Second down and 3 coming up. Walker in the ball game. You're going to see a lot of runs. Wes Hills, Jalen Randolph. We saw Jefferson a little bit. Only one wide receiver has caught a pass today, and that's Deontay Cherry. He's got 5. He's also thrown for a touchdown. That's the only score of the day for Delaware. A 22-yard toss from Cherry to Jalen Randolph. They're down by 6 are the Blue Hens at their own 41.
And remember, Walker's a redshirt freshman, but by title only because of that NCAA clearinghouse issue. He did not get to participate in team activities last year.
Walker participating now on second down and 3. Randolph avoids a tackler in the backfield, but Jacksonville swarms at the 37-yard line, 38. And Delaware goes backwards on second down.
If the ends don't find some sort of a passing attack, though, I don't care how good your offensive line is, when the defense can play completely downhill the way that Jacksonville has tonight, and you're going to face much better, much bigger, much faster defenses than what the ends have seen here for the Dolphins, it's going to be tough to do much offensively. Through lack of options, they're just very predictable right now.
Third down and 7 for Delaware from their own 37. Snap to Walker. Walker throwing far side of the field, and that's a drop pass by Deontay Cherry. Hit him in the hands at the 45. Would have been good for a first down pickup. Instead, we'll see Eric Anderson.
Sat down in the window of zone. Brandon Rowe was a little late coming over. That was a perfectly thrown football by Walker right through the hands of Cherry, who had such a good first half. Does not have a catch here in the second half, however.
And you hate to see that from Cherry, the guy that you're looking towards, the only guy returning from last year's team at the wide receiver position that has caught a pass. Terrence Bryant will return after the timeout from Jacksonville. We'll take a break with him. Your PNC Bank timeout score, Jacksonville 13, Delaware 7. 8:18 left in the fourth.
For over 38 years, Brandywine Electronics has been a reliable asset to the Delaware Valley audiovisual community. BEL is known for the highest level of quality audio services for special events, installation, and service needs. BEL AV designs can be found in boardrooms, classrooms, stadiums, and restaurants across the area. What did the University of Delaware, Point to Point, the Polar Bear Plunge, AAA, President Bush, and President Clinton all have in common? They were all powered by Brandywine Electronics. Visit BEL.com for more information.
Discover why thousands of people choose American Spirit Federal Credit Union. You can find more information online at AmericanSpirit.org. That's AmericanSpirit.org.
What's football, Rich? It's award-winning wings, cold beers served right to your seat, and all the football action you can handle on wall-to-wall TVs. It's Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
This is Blue Hens Country, 94.7 WDSD.
You're listening to 94.7 WDSD and HSRN, Heritage Sports Radio Network, on Sirius XM tonight, part of that CAA package on Sirius XM. Fourth down for the Hens coming up, fourth and 7, down by 6. It's 13-7, just a lack of balance for Delaware here in the second half.
None whatsoever. Delaware has 2 completions since halftime, negative 2 yards passing in the second half. Jalen Randolph has caught 2 balls for minus 2 yards. That's it. Everything has been on the ground. Jacksonville has recognized it. They are playing 8, 9, 10 bodies up near the line of scrimmage. There's just nowhere to run. You knew it was going to be a process. You knew it was going to be tough with these young quarterbacks. I just didn't know it was going to be quite this rough.
Anderson on 4th and 7 from the 37. It's high. It's long. Bryant takes it at the 12-yard line. Breaks 2 tackles. Leaps over another Delaware defenders. It was Ray Jones who got him. Justin Watson was also there. And with 8:08 on the fourth quarter clock, Jacksonville will take over on offense. 45 yards on the punt by Eric Anderson. Terrence Bryant got upended on that return. He's been a Pretty dangerous return man, though, so far in this football game.
I got to be honest with you. Normally I try to help you with the yardages on the punt. I was so shocked by the way he went airborne and kind of did a half flip, half pirouette in the sky. I mean, that was some awe-inspiring stuff. You heard the ooh from the crowd. And this is a must-stop for Delaware. Obviously, a field goal would end it, but even still, you can't let him burn too much time either.
Ready, man.
First and 10 for Jacksonville. Bell rolling to his left, throwing near his own sideline. Caught by Damian Strange at the 45-yard line. That's the third first down pickup from Strange alone in the second half. And Bell in rhythm with his junior wide receiver.
Bell had a little bit more time that time. He escaped to the left off of play action and set his feet before he threw that time. Left-hander rolling left. That's an easier throw for him.
Skukalek is the tight end. Ajama is the running back on first and 10. They'll go to Ajama on the draw play. He darts to the 49-yard line before he's met by Josh Plummer. And with 7:38 and ticking, Jacksonville has it second down and 6.
Yeah, Jacksonville's like to go fast tonight, but I don't think this is the time to do it if you're the Dolphins. You don't necessarily have to take the air out of the football, but, you know, it's time and score. You're up by 6, under 7.5 to go in the final period, and here they are taking their time. The clock is in your favor if you're the Dolphins. You're 7.25 minutes away from pulling off arguably the biggest win in school history.
Kerwin Bell saying before this game, this is the toughest game on the schedule for the Jacksonville Dolphins out of the Pioneer League. Bell again out of shotgun. Screen pass this time to Ajama. Caught at the 45, turns upfield at the 50. And in space, a tackle made by Delaware's Jalen Kindle, who was a high school teammate of quarterback Cade Bell at Fleming Island.
Now, Jacksonville technically is a non-scholarship program, but that has to have a huge asterisk. The reason why they're ineligible for the postseason this year is because they've been giving scholarships. They've been finding leeway through that hole, some academic scholarships, some different ways to get their players money that's legal NCAA-wise. They can still have a program, but against the rules of the Pioneer League. So it's not quite like you're losing to an Ivy League school.
Nickel package again for Delaware. Atmarase on the sideline has kept his eye on that all night. Third down and 5 from midfield. Bell throwing wide for his target at the 45. He was looking for Andy Jones, and it comes incomplete. Bell upset with his receiver, but it's fourth down and 5, 6:18 to play.
You know, maybe his receiver went the wrong way on the other side of the field, but I would be upset with myself right now if I'm Bell. Just didn't set his feet again. Quick throw, wide open receiver in the flat for a first down. Maybe he got overexcited that he saw the receiver open. That would have been a critical first down if you're Jacksonville, and he just completely missed the throw.
Bell, 24 of 41 after that incomplete pass, nearly blocked on the punt. Terry back to return. He gets away from it. It rolls, taking a Jacksonville hop from the 15 inside the 10, now inside the 5. Wow. What a bounce for Jacksonville, a 47-yard punt for the Dolphins, and Delaware will start at their own 2-yard line, down by 6, 13-7, 6:03 remaining in the fourth quarter of action here on the first game of the season for the Hens.
Oh, the true freshman from the First State had a chance to make this a magical night. He came in pretty much untouched from the edge and almost blocked that punt. You talk about a game of inches. He was not off by more than a couple of inches. And now speaking of freshmen, quite the task in front of the redshirt freshman, Joe Walker, right now. Backed up all the way at his own 3, and field goal doesn't do much good. He needs 6, which means 97 yards. That's a lot of real estate.
I form from the 3-yard line to start. Wes Hills trying to give him some space, does so as he gets across the 5, tackled at the 6.5-yard line. It'll be second down coming up for the Hens under 6 minutes to go, down 6.
If you're Delaware, I think you got to pick up the pace here a little bit, unless you're planning on going 97. If you pick up a couple of first downs, but, you know, tick 3 minutes or so off the clock, you're going to make it awful tough for yourself to get the football back. You can't really afford to let 35, 40 seconds go off between snaps here.
Delaware only 2 first downs in the second half as Walker goes under center. And again, I form, again, Wes Hills, again. A pickup of over 4 yards, marked down at the 11-yard line, and it'll be third down and close.
Yeah, long one, short two. Probably closer to a short two here. But that allows you to keep the ball on the ground if you want to. But again, we're going to be under 5 minutes now before this ball is snapped, and under 5 minutes by a pretty wide margin. Walker's not even over in the huddle yet. Starting to pin an awful lot on this drive.
You're absolutely right. Walker very late to get that signal from the sideline. Comes under center on third down and two from his own 11. And he's going to roll out right side. Throwing to Whaley and incomplete. A lot of zip on that pass. And it falls incomplete. Fourth down and two. And they're going to have to punt as Anderson comes out. Another three and out for Delaware. That's a timeout. We'll take a break before the punt. Your PNC Bank timeout score, Jacksonville 13, Delaware 7, 4:44 to play.
Capriati Sandwich Shop has catering available for all your tailgating needs. Stop into the New Ark Shopping Center, Lantana Square in Hokesson, or Kirkwood Highway locations and fill up on the delicious and award-winning sandwiches like the Bobby and the Capistrami, or order online at capriotis.com from any of those three locations. And make sure to download the Capriati's loyalty app to get free food. Capriati Sandwich Shop in New Ark, Hokesson, and Kirkwood Highway. Proud supporters of Blue Hen Sports.
Think you're the Blue Hens' number one fan? Stop into any one of the 85 businesses in People's Plaza and register to be the People's Plaza Fan of the Game. Visit peoplesplaza.com for more info.
Even big-time executives get Labor Day off. But at Executive Auto Group, we're working this weekend, including Labor Day, so you don't have to. That's right, we're making car buying easy at our huge Labor Day sales event with extended hours and, of course, great deals on that new or pre-owned car or truck you've been eyeballing. So this weekend, make an executive decision. Relax, have fun, and show up at Uncle Morty's cookout in the car of your dreams. Executive Auto Group, 11 great franchises. Visit executiveautogroup.com for details.
Back here at Delaware Stadium as Eric Anderson gets off the punt from the end zone. Dallas Jackson back to return. Fair catch at the 48-yard line. So Jacksonville will start things off near midfield with a 6-point lead after a 41-yard punt, no return from Eric Anderson. Delaware needs to get a stop quickly. Let's set it down to Michael Attanase on the sideline.
Now, guys, Cade Bell and the Jacksonville offense is going to go into what we call four-minute offense. They will run the ball, be slow to the huddle, be slow to the line of scrimmage, because obviously they don't want to give the ball back. Delaware is going to have to do something drastic, whether it's put another guy in the box or bring that blitz off the outside again. We're going to probably see high-intensity blitzes and a lot of pressure here.
We'll keep an eye out for that. Good reporting from Michael Attanase on the sideline. With 4:37 left and a 6-point lead, it's first and 10 from the 48. There's a run from Ajama, and he gets into the second unit of Delaware, across the 45 to the 42-yard line. And I believe that's enough for a first down.
It's not, and to be honest, that's bad news for Delaware. I'd rather have him pick up a first down, because now they can burn another 30, 35 seconds off the clock, have a high percentage chance of picking this one up. Delaware's got three timeouts, which means you can allow them to get two more first downs, to have a realistic chance of getting the ball back with some time. But two more first downs puts them in field goal range, so you're really starting to run up against it if you're the Hens.
And a very good field goal kicker who's made it from 42 and 41. Second down and one, ball at the Delaware 43. Some movement, Woodson pointing at the offensive line of Jacksonville, and another false start for the Dolphins.
Oh, that was close. Hens got a break there.
That's penalty number 10 for 70 yards for Jacksonville so far in this football game. Delaware's been penalized five times for 34.
And Ridderoff has been the guilty party on a bunch of them. He picks that one up, and that's a huge cost. So much for being happy that won a first down. Now it's second down and six. Realistic chance to get off the field.
Pistol here as Bell goes in shotgun form with Ajama with a 9-yard run to start this drive. 3:40 to play. Bell looking downfield, nothing doing, running, looking, still being chased, throws a dart for a first down at the 37-yard line to Andy Jones. What a nice job by Bell to keep that play alive and get out of the pursuit of the Blue Hens moving the sticks.
And then what a hustle play by Travion Wallace. Cam Kitchen was coming in untouched and was going to blow Bell up. But at the last second, out of nowhere, hustling back into the play was Wallace. He got enough of Kitchen that bought Bell that extra second and fires the first down pass. And now you're out of leeway if you're Delaware.
3:10 and ticking. 13-7 is the lead for Jacksonville. Ball at the Delaware 38-yard line. In motion goes Chris Kukulek from left to right. Ajama gets the feed, starts left, moves right across the 35-yard line and down at the 32. Charlie Bell with the tackle and a timeout taken by Delaware. And as we take a timeout here at Delaware Stadium, a look at some of the stats in this ball game. We talked about Cade Bell a lot in the opening. 25 of 42, 269 yards, a touchdown. On the ground, he's the leading rusher with 28 yards for Jacksonville. Andy Jones, who had a first down catch moments ago, 9 catches, 118 yards, and a touchdown for Delaware. They've rotated quarterbacks. Blake Rankin, 6 of 10 for 60 yards. Walker, 1 of 6 for just 6 yards in the air. And Cherry with a touchdown pass. He's 1 of 1. 16 carries for West Hills, 88 yards, leads the way for Delaware.
If you're the Hens right now, the proverbial back to the wall, because you talked about the field goal kicker, how effective he is. You're just starting to run out of real estate in terms of how much more room you can give up. He was 13 of 18 on field goals a season ago. He knocked down one greater than 50. He was 1 of 2 from 50 or more. He was 2 of 3 between 40 and 50. So you're right on the edge, really technically at the edge of his field goal range.
Delaware 2 timeouts after that one. Second down and 5. Delaware 33-yard line. Bell going long and intercepted. Coming over to pick it off is Ryan Torza. Bell floated it, and the junior picks it off. Why throw the football there?
Well, if you're going to throw it, why take the shot? If it's there, toss it. If not, we've talked about it all night. Cade Bell, the Riverboat Gambler. Now, the receiver had a step on the corner, Watson, but Torza, that's a phenomenal athletic play from his safety position. He took 2 hard steps towards his left, saw Bell's eyes, broke immediately to the outside, but way too much air under that football and thrown to the inside shoulder when that had to be to the outside shoulder. Fantastic play by Torza. Bad read, bad throw by Bell. Big break, Hens with life.
They'll start on their own 3-yard line. And Walker going to keep it, turning the corner, at least trying to, at the 5-yard line. Good pursuit by the defender. It was DJ Howard, the senior linebacker, who got him at the 5. A 2-yard pickup, 2:32 and ticking. Delaware, 2 timeouts after the Ryan Torza interception. He had the first interception of the season for Delaware last year. That came in week 5. Another big play for the free safety. We'll see Walker go back in shotgun form this time. His feet near the goal line at the 1. Second down and 8. Walker hit in the end zone. Ball is loose, and it's recovered by Jacksonville for a touchdown with 2:09 remaining. They go up 19-7 here at Delaware Stadium. It was DJ Howard. We had just called his name. And the team that had 30 takeaways a season ago gets one in the end zone this time for 6.
They ran a stunt on the right end. End went inside, tackle went wide. Pretty much came in untouched. Walker expecting that to be picked up as a celebration penalty against Jacksonville and just got blind sided, speared at the back, right as he was at the apex, cocking to throw. The ball flipping up in the air and a very disappointing finish. It was, you know, long odds to try to get down the field and score there, but to not even give yourself a chance, that one stinks.
It certainly does, and if there was any air left in this stadium, it has left after that touchdown. Some movement before the snap on the PAT, 2:09 remaining. And Delaware, who has just not been able to move the football in the second half, only 2 first downs in the entire second half of action, now down 2 scores.
Negative 2 yards through the air. You cannot sustain an offense that is entirely one-dimensional, no matter how strong that one dimension is. And the inability to throw it just destroyed the Delaware running attack in that second half.
Another false start for Jacksonville. They're moved back. This will be a 25-yard PAT. And it's up and through. 20-7 is the count. Jacksonville on top of Delaware here in the season opener. Delaware has won 7 of their last 10. season opener games. Their three losses in that span were to the big-time schools of Navy, Maryland, and Pittsburgh. They lost last year to Pittsburgh. This one looking like it's going to go that way again, this time against Jacksonville out of the FCS. Want to remind our listeners that WDSD broadcaster powered by Brandywine Electronics at BEL.com. I was able to check out their new location at 611 Carson Drive in Bear, and it is impressive. Their work is impressive as well. We work with Joe, but it was great to be able to meet some of the other geniuses that work over at Brandywine. WDSD puts their trust in Brandywine Electronics and have been for years. We work with BEL throughout the offseason to improve the audio quality each season. We appreciate the time they take to help us out. Visit them at BEL.com.
It's not going to be a happy Labor Day for the Hens. You get the feeling they're going to be back at practice. And I got some things to work on. And, they're not going to win this game unless something miraculous happens. Again, probably shouldn't say that. They won a game last year where they were or 2 years ago where they were down by 13 with, 30 seconds left on the clock. So I guess you should say never say never. But unlikely to win this game. You have to find something positive through the air here. Even if it's against a soft defense, it's kind of giving you some space. You're going to have to generate some sort of balance or just some sort of respect for the passing game, or it's going to be a long year.
Kickoff from the 20 after the celebration penalty, and Ray Jones takes it across the 25 to the 30 at the 40-yard line, sprinting and still running at the 45 to the 50 and in Jacksonville territory at the 46-yard line. It was Ray Jones who shed a couple of tackles, and this gives Delaware perhaps some life. Exactly 2 minutes left on the fourth quarter clock, down by 13, and Walker back in at quarterback.
You know, worst case scenario, it's a young guy making a play. I mean, the one thing you can't lose sight of, so many inexperienced young guys are going to be out here for the next 3-4 years. You don't want to be accused of towing the company line, but it's true. I mean, you look at it, there's so much inexperience. You just need to see growth. This team needs to get better and better each week, and maybe this can be the start of that process.
Walker in shotgun form from the Jacksonville 46. On the slant, a bullet pass thrown the way of Trey Brown, and it falls incomplete. It hit him right between the 1 and the 5. Another drop, a drop earlier on a pass he threw to Deontay Cherry.
That's perfect throw. I mean, you cannot throw the football any better than that. Away from the defender, almost in stride, a little bit low to avoid any type of deflection. He's got to catch the ball.
1:56 now. Second down and 10 ball on the Jacksonville 46. Walker throwing again. Same play this time. Caught by Trey Brown at the 31-yard line. That was a bullet pass by Joe Walker. Clock will stop momentarily to move the chains. Walker going fast. Shotgun snap. First and 10 from the 31. Steps up in the pocket. Being chased. Stiff arm. Stays alive. And he's hit backwards at the 33-yard line. It was Trey Davis, a six-year senior, that put him down, in a timeout taken by Delaware after the sack. 1:36 left to play. Walker to Trey Brown, got the first down, but then pressure on that play a moment ago by Jacksonville sends Delaware backwards, but it does stop the clock with this timeout. Delaware will have one timeout remaining with 1:36 to go.
The one concern with this offensive line, nothing has looked all that good in the passing game today. Great run blocking unit. They have struggled though pass blocking tonight. And when Blake Rankin was in there, he was under some pressure. And Walker, some of it is the inexperience and the youth showing that has so much confidence in his legs, and he's looking for the opportunity to run. But there have been a couple of times where I thought he tried to set up in the pocket. There just wasn't a pocket there for him to set up in. As soon as his back foot hit, he had to get out on the move and escape and try to make something happen because there were bodies in the backfield around him.
Ricky Bell in, Riley Angeline in the game. As Walker back in shotgun form, trips to the far side of the field on 2nd and 11 from the Jacksonville 32. Walker at the 5-yard line. It's caught by Angeline. He's trying to reach for the end zone. Still pushing forward at the 1. Marked down at the 1-yard line. Riley Angeline's first catch of his career, and it's a big one.
Got to go fast here. You're down to one timeout. It's going to be an onside kick no matter what, but you can't afford to waste much time after they start this clock.
It's frozen at 1:27. Now it goes on the official's whistle. Walker under center. Give is to the back, and a touchdown by Jalen Randolph with 1:20 left, and Delaware makes it a 7-point game.
Give credit to a young football team there.
Ray Jones sparked it with that kick return. So much has gone wrong tonight. They made something go right here late. And you're going to need an onside kick, but at least something positive to build on, if nothing else.
Anderson will hold. Snap from Fortunato. Rago for the PAT. That's up and through, and Jacksonville leads 20-14 now after Walker got it to Angeline, and Randolph finished it off. That dash into the end zone by Jalen Randolph, brought to you by Dash In. Download the Dash In app by texting WDSD to 55123, and you'll get weekly free item savings and a whole lot more. We'll be at the Dash In and Shell on Paper Mill Road in Newark on Tuesday, giving away free Blue Hen gear and tickets from 4 to 6 p.m. Come see us. Let's send it down to Michael Atrase on the sideline.
Guys, talking about silver linings, do you know why I love young guys stepping up, the resolve? No one put their head down. They got back down to business, started with Buck Jones on the return, and then Walker, all right, perfect pass. Another young guy on Ange on the catch and the reach for the end zone. These guys, they're showing resolve, and that's what you love to see out of a young team. Let's see if they could get this onside kick.
And Trey Brown, who's a redshirt freshman, dropped that first one. That was a great catch on the second with a diving grab that got everything jump-started. And how about Walker? A couple frozen ropes. Great point by Atan Raja there. They're not giving up. And that's a good sign for a young team. We came out with, you know, some high hopes here on opening day, flying around, the exuberance of youth. And nothing went right until that last drive. But, you know, it's good to see them fight back and make something positive happen this evening. Give yourself a chance. Maybe you get an opportunity here. Maybe you get a lucky break. And who knows what happens.
Kevin McLaughlin is the kicker. And a timeout taken by Jacksonville. They'll have one left. Mind you're listening to WDSD 94.7 FM Wilmington Dover, also on HSRN Sirius XM Satellite Radio with their partnership with the CAA. 80 seconds left on the clock. Jacksonville up 20-14. Their most recent score was a recovered fumble in the end zone of Delaware, but then it was Joe Walker and company going five plays, 46 yards up the field, and Jalen Randolph punching it in from a yard away. We've seen him do that plenty of times before. Now it just comes down to Delaware getting this onside kick. We've seen it, as you alluded to earlier in the broadcast, Matt, down at Towson a couple years back.
Yeah, that was two touchdowns in less than 30 seconds. They erased that deficit. Here, a little bit more time left for the clock, but with one timeout, you know, it's over if you don't get this one here, but see what McLaughlin can do. Jacksonville called the timeout. They saw how Delaware came out alignment-wise. It was almost like a basketball game broke out here in the final 80 seconds.
Comes down to this with 1:20 left and only one timeout for Delaware. They've got to get this onside kick. McLaughlin has it teed up on the far hash at the 35-yard line. Hands team in for Delaware. McLaughlin runs up. It bounces touch before it goes 10 yards. And that's just a mistake by Delaware. It was Ryan Torzu who made the interception a couple of series ago on defense for Delaware, and the junior kind of smacked the football. He knew better than to do that. And because of the mistake and the mental error, that'll probably put a W in the win column to start the season for the Dolphins.
That hurts. That actually looked like it was set up to maybe take a high hop. I'm not sure if Torzu just got going too far up the field and kind of got caught, almost like a game of dodgeball there. Or if he thought he could get a little further up the field than he could, or than he was, and maybe could grab it at the 10-yard mark on the dot. I think he got going a little too far for his own good. I mean, if you kick that any shorter, it's not going to go 10 yards on the bounce.
Delaware defense will come in. Hens starting with Jacksonville. Lafayette coming to town next week, and then, wow, Villanova, North Carolina, William and Mary after that. We'll talk a whole lot in the postgame show about what's to come for Delaware, but a disappointing first night of the season for the Delaware Blue Hens as Jacksonville flies up to the First State. And Cade Bell takes a knee. He'll have to take a couple of those as Delaware will call a timeout, their final timeout, down 20-14. And now Delaware kind of looking towards the sideline as They'll just stand out there. Not much you can do right now.
It's
down 20-14.
Most painful part of football. I mean, it really is right now. There's absolutely nothing you can do. You just stand around. You're waiting, and the clock's going to go off, go down. I mean, there's really nothing else. If you're Delaware, that you can do, you kind of just have to stand there perilously. You have to take that last time out if you're David Brock. For Dave Brock, I mean, it's a lonely feeling for him right now as well. I mean, he knew this was going to be a challenge. He has said many times, we have to get better week in, week out. We will not be the product we give you on opening day at the end of the season. Well, certainly that better ring true, but he knows a lot of work to do between now and next week against Lafayette because his schedule is just going to get tougher here over the next month.
A lot of promise on that final drive to build off of, but just running out of time are the Blue Hens, and they ran out of time as K-Bell takes the knee again. He'll have to do it again. 107 and ticking, and Jacksonville going to come away with a 20-14 victory. I will say this. It is Jacksonville. They are out of the Pioneer League team. Delaware did not play their best football, that's for sure. A lot of kinks to work out for a young, inexperienced football team. But Jacksonville is a good football team. And
they are. And this is their Super Bowl. They're not a postseason eligible team this year. They talked about how much this one meant. You got to find a way to win this game, though, you'd think, if you're Delaware. But it's a young team. There's going to be growing pains. I just think now you have a better idea of how tough it's going to be. And how far you have to go. And I think Dave Brock and his staff will go back to work.
Jacksonville takes the final knee to make it official as the clock will tick down. Coaches shaking hands at midfield, and Jacksonville will start the season 1-0 with a 20-14 victory over Delaware, coming into Delaware Stadium and winning the season opener. We'll have a lot to cover in the postgame show. It's the American Spirit Federal Credit Union postgame show. We'll talk with head coach Dave Brock. We'll talk to our captain, David Tinsley. Michael Attenrausse will take care of that. But certainly a disappointing start to the season for Delaware. He had a lot of questions coming in, and we'll address all of those. As far as who's the quarterback, maybe Walker after today, but no one really stood out. No one was a star ahead of another one. Walker, we showed his quickness, what he can do with his feet, and I think Walker has potential to be very, very good, and we saw that today, but there wasn't one guy that was leaps and bounds better than the other today.
No, and you hate to say this if you're Blake Rankin, who didn't really do anything to hurt himself, but it was very similar to what we thought we'd get coming in from what Dave Brock said. You know, much higher ceiling from Joe Walker, the opportunity to be great. Rankin's ceiling maybe a little bit lower, but you're hoping he'll make fewer mistakes. Now, Walker didn't make a ton of mistakes tonight, but he had a play or two maybe that he could have converted that he didn't in the early portion of that second half, the early portion of that fourth quarter when he was out there, but he's a freshman, and Rankin's a junior, and this is clearly a team that's building around youth, and you know it's got some room where it's got to make up some growth that has to happen to get where they're back in contention in one of the tougher FCS conferences in the country. So, you know, if it's me, and I'm not Dave Brock, and I don't pretend to know anywhere near as much football as Dave Brock, but I would err on the side probably of youth if I'm Delaware and just keep this youth movement going. If I got a guy who I believe in long-term in Walker, give him the keys, and at the very least, give him a year to see if he's not the answer. I got to go out and find the answer, you know, one or the other.
I agree with you 100%. If it's going to be a season where you're having a youthful football team out there, the future is in the hands of Joe Walker. And we saw glimpses of it today, not for a long period of time, but especially on that final drive, a couple of drop passes that he threw, and that's what his stat line of 3 of 9. You know, that could easily be 5 of 9, I think, with a couple of drop passes. That final drive, he got one to Brown, he got one to Angeline, used something with his legs. And I agree. I think Walker is the guy moving forward. Again, you're right. Nothing that Rankin did really to hurt himself, but he certainly didn't do